So we're recording.
Oh, excellent. Yeah,
it doesn't matter because we can start talking whenever. Because I was noticing on one of our conversations, we were talking for a good 5 minutes, and then it seems like I remembered to turn on the mic.
it picked up like in the middle of our conversation.
It was super, super low, and then all of a sudden, boom, it picked up because I turned on the mic or I did something. And then the volume started to kick up, and I was like, dang. But it was like right when we hopped in the car.
Oh,
and then
yeah.
You were like, yeah, they were kind of stinky. You were saying,
right.
Yeah, and then I
wasn't talking shit.
No. I know
I was making an observation, and I had to clean my car out really well because when I was vacuuming, like, I actually had to get in there with, like, wiping stuff down just because there was so much dust. Like, my car was filthy, and it wasn't just from them. It was, like, all in the front, too.
Yeah, from us walking around.
Yeah, it was a dirty day. It was awesome.
I think I came home. I didn't even take a shower. I just passed the fuck out.
Oh, my God, really?
Yeah, I just, like, passed out. And then I smelled myself when I woke up in the morning. I was like, damn. Because it was just so sweaty.
It was so hot that day.
Yeah. But it was fucking fun. It was fun.
Yeah, I think I drank that whole gallon of water that I took from you. Like, the one that I started drinking in the car. I was just like, I drank it right out of the bottle.
Dehydrated. Mm-hmm. Yeah. Okay. Okay, so, I don't know. We can kick this off whenever we want.
So, should we welcome to Mind Slut?
Yeah, it doesn't matter. It could be whatever, right? Welcome to the first of hopefully many mind-altering, in my mind, psychedelic conversations on Mind Slut.
Mind Slut.
Yeah.
That's a great name.
It is. It's a good thing you came up with it.
It's a pretty good thing I came up with it.
Yeah, yeah.
Otherwise, what would we be called?
I don't know. Probably something kind of shitty. Yeah, we would have probably been thinking, oh, what about this?
Or, if you think too hard about it, it doesn't come.
Yeah, yeah. But then that does help, though, that in part of our mission or our vision is that we actually have a place where substances can be used to allow ideas to flow freely.
Yes.
Right? Because it was when we were using substances called alcohol, when you came up with the idea of Mind Slut.
That's correct.
Yeah.
Yes, that's right.
Yeah.
I feel like I'm breathing heavily into this, am I?
I don't know.
Can you hear me? Am I like...
No, you don't sound like a mouth breather.
I'm trying not
to
be a mouth breather. All right.
Yeah, but at any rate, we you can always go and hop on mindslut.life.
Fuck yeah.
mindslut.life, and then you can see why the fuck we're doing this. But yeah, it's more or less just a place where we can share our ideas.
It's awesome.
Yeah.
Brilliant.
Yeah. I want to look at it and then read what the other stuff that I have written down is right
what,
now.
What, in your book? Or
I don't
there?
Know. I have it both places.
Oh.
I have the book, the computer. But I don't know.
So, how, like, when I was reading it, and I like how you outlined it and, like, the why, how, you know,
yeah.
all of that.
Yeah.
When you, like, when I'm looking at the why, like, what was it that made you come up with this whole idea to do any kind of any sessions like this?
Well, okay. Through a lot of reading and a lot of research and making observations about the shit that's going on in our world that we live in, with the evolution of our technology, right? Now, we all have the ability to be our own media networks. We've never had that capability ever before in life, where we can be the creators of our own content, and then we can manifest all sorts of interesting ideas. Where before, we used to depend on other people to give us these ideas, right? So the way that we evolve and share these ideas is through conversation,
mm-hmm.
right? That's how all things beautiful have ever been created, is like through people sharing concepts with each other.
Right.
Yeah, so that's where that why section came out.
Okay, cool.
Yeah. Does it make sense? Because you got to be a little bit curious.
Yeah, well, I mean, it's just, for me, it was just kind of like, hey, you want to come over and do this, you know, I have all this podcasting equipment and blah, blah, blah. I was like, yeah, it sounds fun. But I really never knew why or how it ever came about in your mind, like, to create this. this baby that is Mind Slut.
Yeah. No, but the baby is our baby.
Right? We had a baby.
Yeah. So then if you think about it, like, that's all ideas are. You know, they're just a bunch of people, you know, and then they end up, when we said it, you said slut. Because there is a sexual component to it, meaning, like, through sex, you get diversity, right? When two...
An exchange.
Exactly. I mean,
it's...
Yeah.
And I was thinking about it in terms of our thought process and our topics were just kind of all over the place, so...
Yeah, that's the slutty component
to it. Slutty component.
Yeah. You're like, oh, I'm so promiscuous with my ideas right now. Look at that one. That one looks good. Let's go mess with it. Oh, yeah. You taste so good right now. Right?
That's
really good. And then you go ahead and then you have a relationship with this idea. Mm-hmm. And then you're like, okay, I'm over you right now. You were
pretty
good.
Or sometimes you have a baby with that idea and then it leads you to a different path.
Yeah, a baby. A baby of an idea in a different path. I like these terms. Because it's like, where it's on here too, it says basic English. Mm-hmm. Right? when we like create this technical language for a lot of the mundane or everyday things that we do, mm-hmm. I think it makes confusion. You know, it brings some form of confusion to lots of people.
Yeah.
And we don't really need to do that. I think we need to find out ways of creating pathways of direct communication with people in order, well, for me, I know, to make my life a little bit better, you know, a little bit more understanding or I don't know, fucking doable.
It needs to be understandable and relatable and not complicated so that anyone on any level, whether you want to get a doctor in here or whether you want to get, you know, swim from the street, like, anybody can just talk across the board.
Yeah, full disclosure, we're going to define terms because swim means someone who isn't me. Of course, that idea was stolen from the internet, like all ideas. Stolen or borrowed from somebody else.
Adopted, because we liked it.
Yeah, but it'll work for us.
It will serve its purpose,
yeah.
For sure.
Yeah, so, I broke down rules of conduct. Right, so the rules of conduct, so, well, I don't know, let's go over this. Should we go over it just from the rip? About our what? Like, what the fuck is Mind Slut?
Yeah.
Okay. So, what the fuck is Mind Slut? And this is broken down in list format because that's just a way of grouping ideas together just to make it digestible, right? You know, you put shit in a list, you can easily track it, you can find out what the meaning of it is, and you can just hop down it, you know, bullet point, bullet point, bullet mm-hmm. point. So first bullet point for what the fuck is Mind Slut? It's a place where ideas are shared.
Easy enough,
yeah.
Right?
Are you going to do it like NPR now?
Oh, place where ideas are shared.
Here, I'll let you read it. That sounds pretty good.
What do I need to read the next
Yeah,
point?
Yeah, just read them all because I like how your voice sounded when you said that.
Place where solutions are worked out. I can't do it seriously.
No, it doesn't have to be serious. But I like the way the voice sounds. I'm like, it's Terry Gross again.
Oh, that's funny. A place where substances are allowed to help ideas flow. A place to talk shit.
Ah, yes. So all of those.
All of those.
Yeah, all of those. We got
a place. Which is why it's important for us to use our acronym, SWIM.
Yes.
We do talk shit sometimes.
Yeah, and then some people would take offense to the shit that we talk.
Yeah.
But when we talk shit and it's anonymous, because anonymity, I guess, in that regards, would be okay.
Yeah.
I know I don't want to really hurt anybody's feelings.
No, absolutely not. And I also think, like, I mean, I just want to say, like, when I do, or I don't know, but I'll speak for myself, when I do talk shit, so to speak, I don't mean to, like, put this person down or degrade them in any way. It's usually, I feel like I'm using them as an example for something that we might be talking about. Like,
exactly.
Oh, for instance, SWIM, you know, did this, and it is kind of talking shit, but that's...
Yeah, but we have to, because these are the experiences that we have. Right?
And I'm not saying, like, well, SWIM is a terrible person, and here's why.
But you know, that's kind of fucked up that we have to do that, because everybody is a little bit so sensitive, right?
Yeah.
Because if they hear their name, then they're immediately going to infer, like, oh my God, is this what this person thought about me?
Yeah, and I would probably think the same thing. I would be like, why am I the example? Or why are they saying that about me?
Yeah, I would immediately ask other questions, though. You know,
what would be your question?
I don't know. Like, if somebody used me, I was like, oh my God, I did that. I wonder what was going on through my mind when I did that particular
thing. Would that make you feel like you needed to be more conscious or conscientious about your behavior, though? Like, should you have to change who you are?
Well, no, but I do modify my behavior quite a bit, especially when it comes
based on how you feel other people, like other people's opinion of you, or?
Well, no, based off of the environment.
Okay.
Right, you know, so, for example, if we walk into an environment or a platform where, say we have no control, you know, we've signed a contract to have some form of employment.
Sure,
with,
okay.
with an individual entity. Right, and so within this entity, we sign over a lot of our rights. You know, we basically remove the freedom aspect that we have when we're outside of those walls, and then we walk in there almost. And this might sound a little fucked. We walk in there as serfs or as slaves, meaning that.
There's a level of conduct or that's expected.
Whatever the jargon it is that we use when we say conduct, ethics, scope of practice, what's your role, all of that is just basically throwing people in containers where they say you can't act outside of those containers. If you do, there will be wrath.
Right? Oh, that's funny.
Yeah. So then that's why, like, so then that's why I was thinking or knowing, like, what we were talking about, like, it would be just safer. To use acronyms.
And then, I agree with it 100%.
Yeah. Since we are, well, I know I can't talk for you, but I know I am. I am a slave. I am a slave, and I work on a plantation, whatever that plantation might be, right? Because now you're going to hear some of my philosophy.
I want to hear it.
Some of my philosophy kick in, because I understand that I give away a lot of my freedoms. Just in order for them to compensate me in some specific way. So I know that I'm rented for a particular amount of period of time.
They need your services, or they want your services. They pay you for them. Mm-hmm. You act in the way that they tell you is appropriate.
Yeah. They say, act like this way. Yeah.
That's an exchange.
Yeah.
That's slut. That's slutty.
Yeah. It's when I prostitute my services.
Exactly.
So, yeah. I am.
We're all prostitutes.
Yeah. Oh, did we have that talk? We had that talk before. I don't know.
We were probably heavily drinking.
Prostitution. So, that's about the what. Did we even talk about the other things in the what? Ideas being shared, solutions? Solutions, yes. Yes.
That's an interesting one.
Yes.
What are your ideas about solutions here? Like, any topic that we cover, what are we going to solve by talking about it?
Well, I know that one of the things that we could solve by talking about it is how we could fix something on an individual level.
Sure. Right? It starts with me.
Yeah. You know, but then the individual can become many super quick, right? Especially, you know, if you start to just like progress and it just looks really good, and then there could be an exponential growth from it. You know, this is like anything that you see. But then the reason why it came up, nobody fucking talks about solutions, right? Whenever you turn it on to the mainstream media, all you see is, you know, oh my God, another bomb went off. Oh my God, you know, this, you know, the kids are going batshit crazy. Oh my God, global warming.
Another shooting.
Yeah.
Everything.
Yeah. Well, tell us, you know, how can we fix this shit? You know, and this is where the solutions, what are the solutions to some of the problems besides, you know, something that really hasn't been thought up? You know, like, there's more or less like a reactionary thing, like with guns.
Take guns away.
Yeah,
instead of, like, educate people or, you know.
Exactly. Which.
It doesn't have to be so extreme, but immediately that's the go-to solution.
Default solution, take whatever it is away that you see.
We're like we're kids that can't behave. We can't be trusted.
Yeah.
No, the kids just need to be educated.
Oh, these children.
Naughty.
And that's what pisses me off, but then I think that we have this optional opportunity to create something where we can have our own little platform. And then even if it's just like us, you know, because you know people, I know people, but then we can sort of kind of like share ideas. Mm-hmm. And then like say if we figure out a way to fix mental health disorders, right? Because you know, well, I guess that's the major problem here in America, is that we have mental health disorders.
Absolutely.
Yeah. And then
well, we used to have places for people who had mental health issues to go, and those were taken away.
Yeah.
Like in the 70s, I guess. Late 70s was it?
80s.
80s?
Yeah.
And now we have like all these people running rampant, like,
yeah.
I mean, I don't know if this is what you're even talking about, but
no,
I mean, I'm thinking
totally
about
is.
People like on the streets that are,
yeah.
You know, we treat them like, I don't know.
We ignore them.
Yeah.
So we
they don't matter.
Yeah.
They're just, you know, vagrants or whatever. But I mean, they're seriously like, they're sick, I think.
Yes.
I mean, they need help and they, you know, we just, we're disgusted and we're like, they're a nuisance. We treat them that way.
That's the problem. How does that thinking even come about? Like, I can see how, based off of the way that our world or our society has been structured, how we would forget about those like that, because then we say that, well, at least that's not me, right? And then, well, to me, that's a shitty way of looking at life, you know, because they're a fellow human being, and then everybody always has an excuse. Well, obviously, they didn't work hard
enough.
That's
what people always say. Like,
yeah.
Oh, well, they must have done drugs. Or
yeah.
They must have dropped out of school, and this is their fault. And
yeah.
Whatever the case, they need help.
Fuck yeah. Yeah.
And even if it's just, I mean, whether it's, like, food or money or education or whatever,
mm-hmm.
they need something. But we're like, oh, get away from me.
No.
You're
know.
Disgusting.
Yeah, and then people tend to chase the, and this is what sort of kind of annoys me a lot, is that then people chase the careers or the jobs that pay them the most, right?
Mm-hmm.
Instead of them doing something to create the most wealth, right? It's a
That's
different.
That's an interesting point.
Yeah, you know, so it's like, well, when you see these people that are out there, like I walk down the street and, I was hopping out of my car. I wasn't walking. I was driving. And then I was over at the 7-Eleven. And this dude, you know, I'm going to call him an urban camper because he's just camping out in the urban woods. And he comes and he hits me up. He's like, hey, man, you got any money? I don't fucking keep change or dollars on me or anything like that. And I was
no
like,
Bitcoins?
Nah. He doesn't have a fucking
yeah.
Bitcoin wallet. So I can't transfer some funds. Like, here, man, boop, go buy you something. So then he was like, well, when I told him, I don't have any change, bro. And he was like, oh, man, okay, cool. Well, can you buy me a sandwich or something? And then I was like, yeah, I'll see what I can do. You know, so when he said that, it triggered. I was like, well, fuck, I'll just buy this dude, you know, I'll buy
sure.
this dude some sandwiches and things like that. Right, but then I saw how many people were out there. He had more people out there, so I bought like 6 or 7 sandwiches.
Oh, my God,
right?
That's so nice.
And, yeah, because I was really going in there to the ATM to fucking get some money. ATM was out of service, so I bought the sandwiches anyway.
Okay.
I bought the sandwiches anyway just to sort of kind of pay it forward, because even though that was just a small, tiny thing, you know, that I did by giving them some food or giving them access to some food, you know, and they were super appreciative of it, right? But how does a human get in a situation like that? And then why do we let them get in a situation like that? And those are some of the things that, even though there's been people who have thought about it, right, they've tried to come up with solutions before.
Well, and then there's another side to it, too. Like, some of those people want to be in that. That's how they want to live.
Yeah.
And they have that right, I think.
I think
that's
so, too.
Not, shouldn't be an issue.
Yeah.
But,
yeah. Which means, why do we chase them away? That's another problem, right? We chase them away when they're in our neighborhood.
Sure.
Yeah, get the fuck out of here.
And there's certain, yeah, I mean, there's certain neighborhoods where they post signage, like, please do not feed the homeless. Please don't help them.
I don't know.
You know? I mean, have you not seen that?
No, I haven't seen that. I've seen it, please do not feed the birds or something like that, but I've never seen please do
I can
not.
Show you where it is. I'm not making it up.
No, I totally believe you because I actually want to see this. That's almost like the same on the same level as the signs that you see when you're close to a border, right? Or the only border that counts is the one where all the brown people are, and that's Mexico, right? You know, so yeah, you know, the brown people are where the problem people come from, supposedly, right? You know, because they're the brown skin, right? but then you see those signs where it says, you know, the crossing, right? Where you see the crossing and it's a sign and it's like a family, right? And you have a father, a mother, and two kids, uh-huh. and they're all running in line, holding, right? So it's a warning that's saying, be careful, there could be people crossing the street, uh-huh. you know, because they're illegal immigrants.
Okay.
And it's a fucked up sign when you look at it, right? Because it's a whole entire family,
yeah.
right? A whole entire family running in a line. It's hilarious, right? But yeah, like it was going on with your, please do not feed the homeless.
I don't know if that's how it was worded, but yes, I have seen those signs in neighborhoods, and just I was like, wow, really? They have to put those up? That's amazing. It's
yeah.
weird, actually, but I know you took that word back, weird. I shouldn't have used it.
No, you can use it.
But
I mean,
I was just like, kind of just didn't. I was taken aback by it, like,
yeah,
because that's my choice whether I want to do that or not, and that sign is not going to influence me whether, you know, one way or the other, to give this person money or not. But I was like, wow.
See, but that's another thing that I hope that we can analyze and discuss and have fun with is propaganda, right? And when I say propaganda, I mean anything that propagates or tries to translate some form of particular mission. Right, because that's how I define propaganda. Something that is propagating or extending somebody's particular mission, whatever the fuck that could be.
Mm-hmm.
Right, because we see it all the time on the news. We see it all the time on the commercials or the advertising and things like that. And then it's just more or less basically. And this is when I can get all tinfoil hat on you and shit. This is where they get into mind control or brain,
okay.
or they're brainwashing you in a specific way. And I hate to say they, meaning. It could be individual corporations or individual organizations, which it's the same.
Well, for lack
thing.
Of a better word, though, the mainstream media, right? Like anything that we get our, anything that we watch on TV or
no,
because
this is a form of propaganda. Everybody does it, right? You know, so it just depends on.
Yeah, we're just not mainstream yet.
No, she's like yet. No, but what it is that you are influencing people with ideas, right? And then sometimes those ideas can overwash the brain in a way that makes you act and respond to a specific way. And then especially when you don't have the capacity to think critically, right? And this is one of the big things that I see or I think that we lack. We lack as a culture. We lack critical thinking skills because we see something and then somebody tells us that's the way it is.
We just accept it or
yeah.
we just, without thinking about it, the why
yeah,
or,
yeah.
or what, but
yeah.
we just do.
Yeah, oh, okay, well, why'd you do that? Well, I read it in the book and they told me. Well, where'd they get their information from? Hands up,
I
don't
know.
I don't know.
I mean, yeah, our culture is like that with everything from like food to, you know, our behaviors to just everything.
Oh my God, food, that's another topic that we're probably going to rip on and have a...
We're going to have to at some point.
But it's a fun time because, like, food is and everything is food, in my opinion.
Well, I have
right?
a loaded gun on that topic. I mean, I have for years.
Yeah, but then yeah, that's what... I can't wait for those conversations between us when we bring some shit out because I know we agree on a lot of fucking things. Probably at least maybe like 90%. 90, maybe even like 99%.
I think so.
Of all the issues that we see with our food because it's like our food is what nourishes our body and it provides us with health.
Yeah, well, and that's how I feel about like working in the medical field. Like, I mean, we see all these people and we rely so heavily on like pharmaceuticals and you know, surgical treatments and whatever, but, this is a topic for another day, but I think about, like, what we do to our bodies with food and drink and whatever.
Yeah.
I mean, that's medicine.
It is.
You know, and people don't think of it that way.
No, it is. It's the first medicine, right? Because, I'm not even going to look up the definition of medicine because there's, like, I'm always going to the etymology, and then I'll bring it up, and then I'll mix my...
It'll bring up a whole bunch of different cultural things, too, like...
Yeah, but, you know, any type of substance that is trying to promote health.
Mm-hmm.
But I burped. It's medicine. yeah, I made sure I didn't burp directly on the mic. Yeah, it was like, blah.
Nice work.
Yeah, but then that's medicine, right? And then you're so fucking right. Food is medicine. And that will be a fun topic to break down. Right.
We could do like a whole, billion hours on that topic.
Yeah. Well,
we don't need to do that, but it'll be a good one. Sure.
That'll probably come up in a series, because that's something else that I think that we can do.
Yeah, there's a whole, there are so many tangents you could go off, like, mm-hmm. There's not just one little...
Mm-mm. No, because with one, we can have many, right? So like food, for example, and then we talk about, like, how you already mentioned, it's medicine, right? Because it's your first form of nutrition. It's what nourishes all the organs and all the systems within your body, right? And then if you're providing your body with shitty nutrients, how's your body going to perform? That's a whole nother topic, right? You know, if you think that you're providing your body with the appropriate nutrients, what the fuck is that? Right?
Right.
It's a whole nother topic, you know?
Yeah, I look at it as, like, preventative medicine. I mean, if you don't treat yourself like crap and, you know...
Yeah.
Eat the right stuff, which, you know, again, what is that? But, I mean, you can prevent a lot of terrible things from happening to yourself.
You just reminded me, like, because I'm on injured reserve right now because my fucking back... My back tweaked out on it, right? But
you should have eaten more spinach then.
No. No, but seriously, on that spinach route, I'm totally thinking about like how I let myself go in a specific way to where my lower back is so weak, it's so fucking weak that when I do something in an inappropriate way, I don't have the strength to protect myself, right? So it's telling me that I'm flawed, right? And I see that I'm flawed right specifically there. Which means, now I'm thinking, what the fuck do I need to do to fix my core, right? To fix my lower back so I can prevent myself from actually having this injury again. Mm-hmm. Because I've had it for a very long time. So now, it just basically means about I'm taking personal responsibility over my body, right? Which I think that's something that we really don't do in this culture anymore.
And it's funny because it's like the only thing you have that's yours. It's like your house. It's your vessel. That's your one thing that you need to take care of.
Right? It is, right?
You just treat it like it's...
No, but think about how much money people will spend to...
To make it look good?
No, not even to make it look good, but say to upgrade their house.
Oh.
Right?
Yeah.
Yeah, it's like, oh, I need a new kitchen.
Yeah.
Right?
Well, I'm diabetic and my foot's going to fall off, but we really need a new countertop or something.
Yeah. It's like, oh shit, did you see that new whatever car, the new latest and great new Tesla? Nah, Tesla's doing pretty good. The new Ford. Ford's doing pretty good too. Right? I need a shitty car.
Shitty car.
I don't know if there are any shitty cars.
They're getting better. Even the cars that used to be shitty are getting better.
What?
Kias are good cars now.
Yeah.
They used to be terrible.
Right? Yeah. Level up. Okay, so yeah, you would just look at, yeah, you know, it's you know, 20 whatever. And I need the next year's model for the new car, right? But then your body could be going out and going like shit. And like you said, it's the one vessel that you're going to have. Damn, I'm a shitty captain right now.
I'm a shitty captain too. We're all guilty.
Damn, you're just a horrible guilt trip.
Oh, yeah. No.
Okay, so yeah, I guess we got two components of it, right? So we've analyzed the place where ideas are shared, and then we analyze a place where solutions are worked out. The substances. Yeah. I think we did talk about that, did we? Because...
We mentioned it, but I don't think we really talked about it.
Yeah. Well, because it was the alcohol that allowed us to even come up with a name when you came up with a name, Mind Slut. Right? And it was because we were just sitting here drinking, shooting the shit.
Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah. We were day drinking.
We were day drinking.
Yeah.
Yeah.
We're out of wine.
We're out of wine. We need to get some more wine.
Yeah, okay. I'm going to go grab the bottle. Look at me hobbling.
Do you want your cane? Your broomstick? Where'd that other thing go?
What are you talking about?
Did I skip a page? Or did you turn the page?
No, I didn't.
Oh, there it is, yeah.
What do you say?
Substances are allowed to help ideas flow.
Yeah, the substances.
So far, the substances are really only alcohol, I think. I'll speak for myself.
Yeah. I was like, speak
for
yourself.
That's the only substance I like.
Yeah, speak for yourself.
Yeah, I will speak for myself only.
Because, you know, I take caffeine in, too. Yeah. You know, I've taken caffeine in. Basically, stimulants and depressants is what I've always ended up consuming.
Do you mix the two?
All the time.
Really?
Yeah. You think about it. Anybody who does a Red Bull and vodka, right? Anybody who does Red Bull and vodka, they've just mixed the stim and the depressant, right? So they're mixing the two in order for them to do something, whatever it is that they think that they're going to do. Because since alcohol is a depressant,
right,
it mellows you out, you know, allows you to feel super chill and relaxed, so you can have these conversations or whatever. You can get the courage to go and say, I'm going to go talk to that girl over there, right? Watch
that,
this.
That makes me think of Swim. Does it make you think
of
Swim?
Yeah, I do. I do. I think of Swim.
Oh.
But yeah, you know, he's like, well, give me another shot before I go, right? Because you need to numb your brain. Numb your brain a little bit so you can get over yourself. And then hopefully say, hello.
Hello.
Hello. I saw you standing over from across the way, and I had to come over here. Yeah, I had to walk over here, and I had to say something to you. But I needed liquid courage, right? So I had to take a shot in order for me to come over here and just say, hello.
That's funny.
Yeah. That's the bar scene. I just broke down the bar scene.
Yeah, you just summed up the whole thing.
Yeah. Damn, we go through all that shit just to say hello.
Why is it even like that?
Isn't that crazy?
That's so weird.
Yeah.
Like, well, and I think this might be, I don't think it's wrong. I think it might be a little bit sexist for me to say this, but I think that's more of like a male, like, because it's usually like a male approaching a female, you know?
Well, yeah.
More often than not. And I mean, for a girl, we kind of just sit there, I guess, and wait for it to happen. I don't really have to worry about, like, oh man, I gotta take a bunch of shots so that if this guy comes and talks to me, I can talk back.
Yeah. How shitty is that?
It's weird. It's very unbalanced.
It is, but then that's the culture. The culture has breeded that type of behavior in us, and that's a shitty fucking.
It's really strange.
Yeah, you know, you go to social environments in order for you to engage with other people. And then there's this whole dance that you have to walk through. And then you just said it, like, I just have to sit there and wait, right? And then if you sit there and wait, just imagine if you weren't the type of person that somebody wanted to talk to. How would you feel? Because you're sitting there and you're waiting because this is what you've been taught to do, and then nobody comes and talks to you, right? What would that do to your self-esteem, right?
I guess I would probably wonder what I was doing wrong, and I would probably, I don't know, I mean, I might, be, I mean, me, who I am, I, if that were the case for me, I would probably try to reverse the roles or something, like, be like, okay, I'm going to talk to somebody, like, you know, have a couple of drinks, and then be like, hey, what's going on, you want to play pool, like, you know,
so I would try to flip it,
I think, because if something's not going to come to you, you got to go get it.
That's true, but then a lot of people don't think like that, you know, they don't think like, that is one of my mottos, if you earn it, you can have it, right? Now, what do you have to do in order to earn it? You got to do some fucking work.
Sure.
You know, you got to put in some work, and that's not our culture.
No, it's not.
Yeah.
Like, what can I get, like, how can I do the least amount of work and get the most of something? That's how we think, you know? Like, okay, like we were talking about the jobs before, like,
yeah.
I want to do the least amount of work and make the most money that I can doing it.
Mm-hmm.
I want to be a fat cat. I want to wear a suit and sit in an office and do nothing and rake in billions of dollars and then get bonuses. I mean,
yeah.
Somebody, I'm not saying that everybody that does that hasn't worked for it, but
oh, yeah,
what about Junior Swim, you know? He inherited the company from his dad, so now he's CEO, and all he has to do is just sit there and let his minions figure things out. And
minions. The little yellow people just popped in my head. The minions.
Yeah.
Yes, minions, go do it. But yeah, that's the crazy part of us as a species. Like, I don't understand why it happens, how it happens, or why we allow it to continue to happen. Yeah, but it's almost like we're functioning on autopilot like that.
Yeah.
You know, it's like...
And well, it seems like the almost the opposite of what should happen. Like, the worker bees, the ones doing all the grunt work, are paid the least. And, like, the kings and the queens, the ones that we're taking care of, are, you know, they're just kind of managing us or whatever it is, and they're making bank.
Yeah. But what you're talking about right now is what we would call, remember, I sent you that link for the American ruling class,
mm-hmm.
right? The American ruling class, that's just how it's designed. And in my opinion, I think that we have this veil, right? We have this veil put up over us where we think that we live in a free society where, you know, we do have economic mobility,
mm-hmm.
you know, where we do think that we're able to function and go from, you know, whatever the fuck it is, one class to the next, right? Based off of our merit or based off of things that we think that we've earned or we've deserved and things like that. In our world, that's just like a fucking fantasy,
mm-hmm.
you know, because you can't go out there and just create your own shit unless you jump through hoops or unless you know the right people,
mm-hmm.
or unless you have the proper social network, right? And to me, I think that's one of the most limiting things for our culture or our society that I see, and I don't understand why that continues to happen.
Why we just kind of accept it as...
Yeah, that's how it is.
That's just how it is.
Yeah. It goes back to that whole, you know, and I don't know, people...
Because it's work. It's work to figure out how to do something, and we don't want to do work.
Yeah, right? Exactly.
We're just lazy.
God damn it, you know.
God damn it.
It's like, how come I don't have that beach physique? Because I got to work for it. Fuck it. Is there a pill
exactly.
that I can take for it? No.
Yes, but it will not give you that. But it will make you think that you can achieve that if you keep taking it. And
yeah.
then you'll have a heart attack. And then you'll sue whoever. And
mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Because they fucked you over.
Yeah.
This is craziness.
So crazy.
Yeah. But yeah. So I guess, that's another thing that we're doing with Mind Slut. We're just doing the fucking work. The intellectual work. Of actually trying to do a thought experiment.
You're just thinking about and sorting out all the different angles of these topics. That's
Which
work.
I think it's fun. It's almost
it is
like
fun
a,
though.
It's like a puzzle. Like I didn't get to play with puzzles when I was younger because I was a feral child.
Oh my god.
Right? Yeah. So
one of these times we should just do puzzles and do Mind Slut at the same time.
Yeah.
I love puzzles.
Yeah. It was like, you will crush me. I must crush you.
I must crush you.
But yeah, you know, so then that's how, but then what's funny, because that's all life is. It's just a big fucking puzzle, right? So then I didn't really get to work on puzzles proper, meaning with a game,
mm-hmm.
but I constantly had to figure out where I would fit in to certain environments because of my upbringing, right?
Okay.
And then that also allowed me to think in a different fashion than I guess I can see a lot
mm-hmm.
of my peers think as, right? Because I had to think autonomously.
Yeah, and to grow up doing that, you know, as a kid, it's probably really hard, but then I think it benefits you as an adult. I think it makes you independent,
mm-hmm.
and...
I don't know why that song popped in my head.
What song?
Independent. INDEP. She got her own house.
Oh my god. I have no idea what that song is.
No, but it's just funny because all
awesome.
They did was just spelled independent, right? And then it said, she got her own house and her own car. But
oh,
yeah,
funny.
Independence though.
And
be,
I don't know anything about your upbringing. Like, really, but
you probably
I kind of feel like I can relate in
mm-hmm.
a lot of ways
because mm-hmm.
at a young age I did the same thing. I had to do a lot of thinking for myself and and from my brother, sort of. You know, there was a little bit of trying to figure life out at a very young age.
Yeah. Which is crazy, because I think that's how it's always been. Right? So when we... Because I don't think that we had an extended adolescence. From listening to what it is that you said, and then what it is that I know that I went through, is that I know most people in a roundabout way have had their adolescence period extended for a very, very long time, where they didn't really have to become independent thinking adults.
Yeah, you're absolutely right. You know? I mean, people that I know and people my age that did things in a way that was, you know, normal, or, you know, they went to their schools and they did their thing and whatever. A lot of people either stayed living, like, with their parents for a longer time to get through school, or, you know, did things just in a way that I am not familiar with.
Yeah.
And so, in a sense, their adolescence was extended, because they didn't have to necessarily pay a rent or a mortgage, or, you know, didn't have to manage, like, a job and life on the side. And I mean, and they had their own things to do. School and jobs and academics and sports, you know, whatever it might have been. I have no idea. But
I have to go to piano class.
I mean, I worked literally, like, basically full-time since I was in high school, you know. And that's why I didn't do sports. I tried, and then
that's the way you walk, the way you walk.
That was the glitter boots. That was the boots. Oh, but that's why you walked away.
Yeah,
I got it. Fuck you. Oh, my God.
She's like, no, I didn't get to do athletics.
So now I don't know how to run and walk properly. Nobody taught me.
Yeah, no, but just joking.
Oh, my God.
Okay.
That's really funny.
Yeah. Yeah, maybe one day I'm just gonna put it like a GIF on the site on how Tame It fucking walks. It's the cutest, funniest thing that you can actually ever see. Yeah.
Oh my God. Now I'm embarrassed.
Yeah, one foot in front of the other. I got it.
Just like life, Tame It. Figure it out. Oh my God.
Ah, yeah. Yeah, but yeah, well, obviously you can tell that you've already had a couple of sips. So then now the conversation.
I'm feeling courageous.
Yeah, it's going to get a little bit livelier as time progresses.
If we were in a bar, you'd be talking to me right now, and I would be talking back to you.
But then I would barely be able to hear you because the music would be so fucking loud. And then I'd be saying, what? And then my ear might be pointed at your lips because I'm trying to hear what you're saying. And then I can just be like, well, fuck it. Just write it down.
Write it down. Yeah. Is that what happens?
No. Well,
that's so funny.
No, but that's what I actually think, or what I feel the times that I've tried to initiate conversations in those environments. Because I can't hear shit because the music's too loud. Right?
Yeah. Unless you're going to the kind of bar that I would probably be at, if it was like a shithole little
dive bar. Fucking
that's
dive
where
bars.
I would be.
I love dive bars.
And they don't sound like the club,
no.
You know?
No. Oh, yeah.
We wouldn't have to be writing things down.
Yeah. What? Wait a minute. Walk over here. The speakers aren't right there. But, I love dive bars. And that's why I really like the Cava.
There's
Cava
a couple
lounge.
Of cool ones in my hood now. Well, they're old. I mean, you know who actually told me about them is Swim from work.
Yeah.
The Irish Swim.
Yeah.
And both places are very cool.
Ah, okay. What's the name?
So, there two that I can think of are Rosie O'Grady's, which is.
It sounds like an Irish pub.
They're both Irish, and then the Old Sod. They're both just little. They're dark, you know, kind of dingy. They're small.
It's off of
Adams Avenue.
Yeah,
both
yeah,
of them.
Yeah.
One's
yeah.
on the corner of Adams and like.
Yeah.
Manchester, I think, and then the other one, I don't remember.
What was it called?
The Old Sod
and
Rosie O'Grady's.
Rosie O'Grady's.
Rosie O'Grady's.
Yeah, fucking little leprechauns running around there. And shit, you walk in there.
Yeah.
Aye, there's a wee leprechaun. you start chasing it for its cereal and shit.
Oh my God.
Do you have your lucky charms? Fuck. Well, that's what I think about whenever I go into Irish pubs for some reason. Funny. Because they throw down. They throw down on fucking whiskey.
Oh, yeah.
Right? Whiskey.
Yeah. And I like Irish whiskey.
Yeah.
A lot better than, well, not better. I like whiskey, but I like Irish whiskey.
Why? Are you, you're proper Irish, right?
I'm not Irish at all.
No?
Scottish, actually.
Ah, Scottish.
Scottish.
Yeah. Yeah. My new, you're okay. My new favorite, playing footsies. My new, I'm watching the new or the old school Doctor Who, like 2000.
Oh, really?
I've 13, never even seen 14? That
show.
What?
I know. I live under a rock.
Are you into sci-fi? Yeah, you wouldn't like it then. It's only the longest running sci-fi.
The only sci-fi thing that I've ever actually really liked was Gattaca.
Oh, Gattaca.
I love that movie.
It was pretty sick.
It was a really good movie.
Yeah, well, you know, Gattaca is about what we're talking about, too, with Mind Slut.
Which part?
Well, yeah, you're right. Which part?
I haven't seen that movie in years.
Yeah, Gattaca.
I love that movie.
No, but if philosophically, when you look at it, it's a brilliant
idea.
Oh,
yeah, because he's trying to, like, fit into this. Or, you know, be in part of this, you know, elite,
a specific
whatever
class.
It is. Yeah.
Yeah, he wants to be part
and
of a group.
He physically doesn't have what it takes, right? I mean...
Well, he did. Did he get sick?
He had some kind of a condition or something. And I vaguely remember, like, the thing that I remember the most is him, like, getting into that little thing and, like, sloughing off all his, like, skin and then putting on the fake, like...
Yeah, yeah. He had to wipe off his DNA.
Yeah, yeah.
His DNA.
Yeah.
Right? And, you know, there's some science behind that because, you know, our skin is always sloughing off.
Yeah.
It's old, dense skin cells. And then somebody could have walked through and scoped that
shit
out.
He had, like, a fake, like, a fingerprint.
Yeah,
you know, that he would put over his finger and, like, put it on the thing and it would scan. And I thought that was cool.
Yeah. But it's crazy. It's crazy that, well, it's a cool thing that he did all that and he had the skills. And this is what bugs me out. About a lot of the shit. When you see movies like that, and then you see the thinking, the logical tools of their mind that they use in order for them to pass in an environment like that, that's some high level thinking, right?
Oh, yeah.
And then for those specific classes to say that, oh, certain people can't come into our environment because they are not intellectually superior.
Mm-hmm.
But they are not physically superior. And I just think that that's like bullshit, which is why I enjoyed Gattaca too. Right? Because he's just like...
Yeah, he was singled out, and he was like, but I can do this.
Yeah.
He knew he could do it.
Yeah, he dropped
the
mic.
He's like, I'm going to do this.
Bitches.
Bitches.
Yeah. Yeah, my back.
Oh, but, my God.
Yeah. But yeah, see, look at that. We just keep going on these tangents.
I know, we have so many topics.
Yeah, many topics. But yeah, all we did was... And I was just only talking about...
We're still on, like, the...
Yeah, we're just on the what section, right? So we're basically... Well, so, as you know, we're just going through our fucking outline on what, why, and how Mind Slut even exists, right? So we've just broken down the first parts, right? So far what we have is a place where ideas are shared, a place where solutions are worked out, a place where substances are allowed to help ideas flow. And then the last part...
NPR special edition Mind Slut.
Yeah, imagine if NPR did have something like
Mind
Slut.
Maybe someday.
You know what? They don't curse on NPR.
Yeah. What can we say instead of swearing?
Fuck swearing.
Sugar puffs. I don't know.
No, that's what's bullshit about language, in my opinion. You say, why is your language right and my language wrong?
And you know what? It's our culture, too. And I just thought about this when we were talking about being Irish and Scottish. Because there was Swim that used to work with us. And she was hilarious. And she was from Scotland. And she would throw out the C word. Like,
I fucking
like we
cunt.
Say bitch.
Yeah.
She would be like, she's a fucking total cunt. And I thought it was so great. I was like, they use it in a way that, like, I mean, in our culture, oh, they're horrified if you say that word.
Yeah.
And... I just loved it.
Yeah, that just shows, because that's why I love vulgar. Vulgar, to me, because I always use it in a Latin sense, it just means the common
language.
Sure.
Vulgarity's not, I mean, I don't know how it ever came to be that we decided to take offense to it. Like, why is that offensive?
Oh, certain cultures. That's why.
But
so,
in our culture, specifically, why are we like, oh, that's not not okay? Why is it okay to say the F word, but
we can't say cunt?
Yeah, ready.
It has a lot to do with our Judeo-Christian cultural foundation, right? So the moment that you talk about some pussy, dick, right? You know, basically that's fucking, right? You can't say fuck, you can't say shit, you can't say dick, pussy. What are the other ones? Fucking George Carlin has all the seven words.
Oh my
words
God, that
can't
guy.
Say, right?
He was brilliant.
Yeah, you know,
awesome.
Seven words, right? You know, seven words. So it goes to show. Hanging out at the plantation. at the plantation earlier this week. And then I did say a word. I said fuck. Right? I said, fuck. Right, whatever. And then,
how many times a day do I say that word?
Yeah.
I can't count.
Who knows, right? You know. But I just like it. Fornication under the consent of the king. Right? That's how I'll break it down.
But that's not even true. That's not even correct.
No, fuck no, it's not. But it doesn't matter.
But it's, yeah.
It's just a word. But somebody said, language. And then I looked at them, and then I was like, what? What do you mean? Right? And I was like, are you trying to marginalize me? I was like, why is that offensive?
I'm offended that you're offended.
Bam! Exactly! Exactly! Right? You know, I was totally thinking that. I was like, well, I was like, you are saying that I can't use my language that I'm comfortable with. Right? Why is that fair?
This is the whole thing that's, like, countrywide right now. You know, the hot topic is just, you know, everyone's offended by this or that or whatever. Mm. And somebody brought up a good point that I have actually recently used. Like, I stole it from this person when I heard it because I thought it was brilliant. Like, the things that we might say or do, and to say, like, well, I'm offended by that. It's like, well, that's fine. Like, you have the right to be offended, but you don't have the right not to be offended. That's not ever promised to you. And so I'm like, that's brilliant. That should just be it. There should be no more discussion about it. Like,
no,
that's it. You know, we need to be sensitive to all of these, whatever, is just so out of control, I think. I want to say cunt.
Say it.
Cunt.
Yeah, you can say whatever you want.
I'm not even sorry. Yeah. Like, who cares?
Okay.
It's just a stupid word.
It is, because you remember, you
am
walk...
Am I a terrible person?
Fuck no, you're not.
No, but that's how people treat you. Sorry. My invisible friend is sitting here.
Yeah. You know, she's over here talking in the microphone's way. The way is way on the outside. Because she's getting animated over a conversation. Yeah. Da 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 da. You know.
Sorry, it's passion. I have to calm down.
Yeah. I am so passionate. Listen.
Oh my God, that's so funny.
But yeah, you're right. You know, you can say cunt. You know, like that. You ever check out that, well, you probably haven't because it's in the movie theater, and of course you don't go to the movies because you've been so busy doing all sorts of things, but there's this particular type of chewing gum commercial. I can't remember which brand it is, whatever, but there's these British people, right? And then,
brilliant.
Yeah, and then the guy, or they change up their words, so instead of saying cunt, they say bunt, right?
Bunt?
Yeah, they say you dirty little butt licker, you, right? But you know what they were inferring, right? And it is beautiful because I know exactly what it is that you're inferring. And this is why, when people say the N-word, I'm like, just fucking say the word. You know, say the word that you know you want to say, but then you don't say the word. So you're so fucking lazy, you make me say the word in my mind, right?
Because even though it's on their tongue, they're afraid that it will offend you.
Exactly.
If they say it.
Exactly. Which goes back to how we're referring to everybody as swim. Right? So we have to refer to everybody as swim because even though they could know who it is that we're talking about, we don't say the name, but we make you say the name. Right? We'll make you say the name.
If somebody was here like, oh, are you talking about me? Like, well, yeah.
Yeah.
Of course.
Yeah. Yeah, exactly. Well,
but to hear their name, you know, without having their permission or without them knowing would be hurtful or offensive or
and
whatever.
You know, and we do say this because we actually happen to work in the world of healthcare. And one of the big things that they beat down in our brains is consent. Consent, consent. Right? So consent.
The stuff of nightmares.
Yeah. Consent just means to with sense. Right? So with your sense, you understand what the fuck is going on. I don't think everybody has full, complete consent over anything that it is that they're doing outside
of
themselves.
Half the people that sign a consent don't even have the...
Yeah.
Don't know what that is.
Yeah. Because if you ask the question, well, what does this mean? It would take a lot of fucking
work. What are we
work.
Doing for you today?
Yeah.
Well, the doctor's going to fix something in my belly.
Yeah.
Like, that's just about it.
And then belly is a container for all sorts of shit.
Like... yeah.
All sorts of shit that can happen. Right? It's crazy.
Yeah.
But this is...
But that makes us feel better because legally we've fulfilled our obligation. They've signed a piece of paper that said, I am okay with this.
Yes. Which just means that all we're doing is just protecting...
We're just protecting ourselves in a legal aspect.
No, not even ourselves. We are the immune system for the organization.
For the hospital.
Yes.
I mean... it's not even really us, but...
Yeah. So
that's where the whole patient care, I care about patients, that whole thing with everybody that browbeats us, I feel like, you're so full of shit.
Yeah, because it's really not about patient
it's
care.
It's not about patient
right.
care.
It's about protecting
the
organism, the institution. Because if it was really about patient care, we would probably be out there... Oh, we just went on
We would be educating
tangent.
People more.
Exactly.
I know, we're doing it again, but...
we would. We would probably be educating people and showing them how they can prevent themselves from getting in this situation.
Oh, here. We don't want to cut your foot off. So, put down the cake. I made some spinach. It's real good.
But then, you know what's fucked up? Because then they have something that's even more insidious. Beating them in the head is advertising.
Mm-hmm.
Right? You know, because everywhere you go... Everything.
Even if it's not an advertisement per se, like you, it's everywhere.
Yeah. Walking down the street, how many commercials or advertisements do you see, right?
Countless.
Just watching YouTube, you know, they'll throw them up in there, but at least they're a little bit more direct.
Every phone app, any, especially the free ones.
Yeah.
I mean, it's constant.
Yeah.
Like.
So now you have two different minds, where you have some people who would be able to look at those. And then just block them out. I'm like, whatever, you know.
Mm-hmm.
But then you have other people who see them, and it's like shiny shit.
Ooh, that's something new. Yeah.
Shiny. What were those? That was in the little group of people in Toy Story.
Oh my God, those little guys, the little aliens in the
the claw. The claw has accepted me.
Oh my God. That's so funny.
But that's basically what advertising does.
Yeah.
Mm, yeah. Damn, we went on another tangent.
Yeah. Where are we? We're still in the beginning.
Yeah. So, we're talking about the why. So, we've already talked about the what. You know, so basically, Mind Slut. It's going to be an alternative news source. It's going to be a hybrid, right, between alternative news source and a think tank.
Yeah. So, it's a little bit random. It's not completely organized, as you can already see, because... We've gone off on a lot of
decentralized,
random little pathways.
But then that's why slut is in there. And then when you think about slut, you think about sex. And then when you think about sex, you know that the purpose of sex is to have
reproduce.
But
ideas
through diversity.
Diversity. Okay.
Sex. You know, sex and sexual selection, because you have to have a diverse group or a diverse information
source.
Otherwise,
it's incestuous.
Yes.
We don't want any of that.
No, because ancestral, if it becomes ancestral, then that means that it's not healthy.
It's not healthy, and things don't change.
No, you might.
Things mutate, and it's unhealthy.
Yeah, you fucking get somebody or something that's anemic. You'd be like, damn, you just keep fucking the same people over and over. And look at you, you're so weak right now, you can't even go get any sunlight. You know, your ideas are kind of weak. There was a slutty aspect of it.
It's all good.
Yeah, but now we were on the why.
I love that picture. I don't know where that is, but I like it.
Oh, it is kind of sexy.
I want to go there.
Is that? No, that might be Paris.
Really?
Yeah, I think it is.
It's something European.
She's like, I know it's not here.
It's definitely not here.
Yeah, it's something European. All right, so now we're on the why part. Okay, so the why part, very simple. So we just want to be curious. We want to exchange ideas. We want to amuse one another, and we want to refine our tastes.
Refine our tastes.
Yes. That does sound a little bit pretentious, but it's not really meant to be pretentious.
But that's just how people might interpret it by that lingo. I mean, it's just to...
Yeah.
to, I don't even know what's another word for refine.
Level up. That's what I like to call it.
Level up.
Yeah. I'm going to level up, bitch. What are you doing? Oh, I got to play a game? Well, how do you get to the next level? I got to get some different armor. Right? It's time to level up. Ding, 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 ding.
Process.
Process. There you go. Yeah, but that's a beautiful thing, too. You know, we can have whatever interpretation that we want of these, but they all fundamentally boil down to growth. Mm-hmm. So in order for you to be curious, you have to have an inquisitive mind. To have an inquisitive mind means you have to be somewhat fearless. You know, to be fearless means you can't give a fuck about whatever anybody else.
Don't give a fuck.
Yeah, what anybody else might think about what it is that you might be doing, and you just go out there and do it, even though that they might be talking shit.
Well,
that's just
being
curious.
That's why cats are so awesome.
I know, right?
They don't give a fuck.
No.
They don't.
My neighbor, she has
the little black cat with the white paws.
Yeah,
it's adorable.
Sunny is her name. It's her.
Oh,
it's a she. Yeah, so
she's the one that talks all the time and rolls around in the grass. Right?
Yeah. No, Sunny was in here the other day.
In here?
Yeah.
Your house?
Yeah. I just brought her. I just let her come in.
Do you want one of my cats?
No.
I'm just kidding.
No. And it's only because I'm too selfish.
I know. We talked about this last time.
But I was like, oh well, shit. I can like sort of kind of flirt with Sunny, right? Because Sunny comes down.
What a good girl.
And she's like, meow, bitch.
Right? Yeah. Touch me.
Yeah.
And then I'll run away when it's too much.
But she was outside when I was here the other day, and then I heard her meowing because I was in the bathroom, you know, of course taking a shit. But but then I heard like meow, right? And I was like, that's got to be Sunny because it was like a persistent meow, meow, meow. And I walk out, and then I see her just sitting out there outside my door looking like,
aww,
meow,
like,
right?
Can you just pay me some attention?
So I open up the door, and then she came in.
That's so cute.
And then she was just like wandering around, having a good time. And then I'm hobbling around with my little broom cane. Right, and I feel like that old dude, like, oh,
you're gonna be on a rascal.
Yeah,
be careful.
Yeah, that would be cool. But then I gave her some water, and then she kicked it on top of the bookshelf, and then she
That's
had fun,
so
and then she was like wandering around, smelling. She's been in here before, and then she went outside when she was over it, you know, after she made her mark. But yeah, cats. Yeah, they
if
don't.
People were like cats, we'd all be like super honest, because they just like they do only what they want, and like when they've had enough, they don't pretend.
Yeah.
They just go about their business, like on to the next, you know.
And they're not
mission.
Very selfish. Meaning they don't try to hoard all the mice.
No, they just try to hoard the one mice that they catch.
Yeah, that's it. You know, they're like, this is enough for me.
So I mean, like, they're selfish in the way that they mostly only care about how they feel in themselves, but I mean, if it's a family you're talking about or a pride, I mean, they take care of one another.
Yeah,
none of my cats are related. My horde of cats that I have, and they don't always all get along. But I have this one cat, and she's like the second youngest of them all, and she has this weird like mothering thing that she does every night when I'm about to feed them. She starts licking everybody in the face, like she cleans them all up.
Grooming them, huh?
Yeah, and it's really funny because she's my meanest cat. She sucks, for lack of a better word. I mean, she'll snuggle with me at night, but she's really mean. But it's funny to me that she's so, like, motherly towards them just at this one time of day. Every single night, like...
That's pretty rad, actually.
Yeah, it's really... It's interesting.
Like, no, it is, because you can probably learn so much from, you know, just observing.
Even though I don't get along with you and I hate you, I still care about you.
Yeah.
We have to live amongst each other, and
yeah,
I'm going to clean you while we wait for our dinner.
But that's what's so beautiful about it, is because they've created their own little tribe.
Yeah, and there's a hierarchy, and it's hilarious.
Oh, there is?
It's so funny. Like, the order that because it doesn't matter where I put their food bowls, they eat in the same order. Like, it is, like, Arnie, Amy, Euglis, Ellen, and then Scotchy. He sits there and he waits until everybody else has their food, and then he eats. And he's like, I've had him for a long time. He's one of my older cats, and he just is so polite and so passive. He just waits for everybody else.
I wouldn't say that's passive. He's the leader.
He's not. He's so timid.
Oh, he's not the leader?
He's
the bitch.
He is. And he was my second cat, and him and my first cat, they are, like, best friends, and they're the only ones that, like, will really, like, play and get along with one another really, really well.
Okay. All right. I know we're going to eat.
Yeah.
That is crazy. Cats.
We might have to do Mind Slut at my house one night.
No, we totally can. We're mobile.
Yes.
Yeah.
All right.
We're totally mobile. We can do it there whenever, too. I think
next
I
week.
That.
Next time we do Mind Slut.
Okay.
And we'll check out those Irish dives.
Yes. And then the how. Right, so the what, why, how. Now we're on the final part of as far as the how is concerned. And it's just through conversation, which means that all we're doing is just running a thought experiment.
Mm-hmm. My wonder is, like, how many people are we going to reach?
Who cares?
Who cares? No, but I mean, I don't know why I do that. Maybe I'm supposed to be a host. Hostess.
Here's the mic.
Like, I mean, this is for us, but also, I mean, we're putting it out there for anybody who may or may not be interested or whatever. But, I mean, say it reaches a whole bunch of people. Say it reaches a specific, you know, group of people that are like, wow, we could really get in on this. And, like, I just kind of wonder, like, how it's going to reach people and how many people it's going to reach.
Okay.
And that remains to be seen. I'm not asking you this. I'm just wondering. Just putting it out there. Curious. Like, I do wonder about that.
Somebody asked me that today. Why are you guys doing it? And I was like, because we can.
Why not?
Yeah, that's what it boils down to. It's like, exactly, why not? You know? Why are we doing it? Well, why not?
Because we have the freedom to at this point. It has not been taken away from us.
Yeah.
Just yet.
No, not yet. Not yet. But yeah, but that's what I'm saying. It's like we are the nodes, you know, because there is, in my opinion, there is a global brain. There's a global consciousness right now that's starting to develop, right? And we're at that early stages of it. And then now all we're doing is just becoming a specific node, right? Node, or in your world, you can call it a specific neuron,
mm-hmm.
right? So you're a neuron, I'm a neuron, right? We're both neurons,
mm-hmm.
and then we're just synaptically
right
connecting
here.
With each other,
yep.
right? So we're transferring this information, and then it could hit up.
It's
other
electric.
Nodes.
This is our. This is the. Where is this going?
Yeah, it's going right into
yeah.
the recorder.
That's our synapse, right?
Yes, it is. But whatever it is, the metaphor, it's the metaphor. It's all the same, though. But is that we're just becoming conduits. For something that's bigger, it's bigger than us, you know, meaning that we have a lot of diseased thinking
mm-hmm.
within the global mind, right? Because when people are thinking about, well, I can't do this, I can't do that, what am I going to do, woe is me, right?
We're in like a weird time where like we're very free, but at the same time a lot of things that could be taken, like, it seems like things could be taken away from us at any moment, like.
And just those words sound so gross to me.
Isn't that crazy?
I know it sounds so gross.
I think about a song lyric taken away from us. Yeah, taken away.
Yeah.
It's almost like, well, we gave you this freedom, but we're not really okay with giving you this freedom, so
yeah.
we want to take it back.
Yeah. It's like, who the fuck are you to be taking away something that is mine?
There's a song lyric that I wanted to bring up just because I thought of it. I was listening to it this morning, and it's, I suggest we learn to love ourselves before it's made illegal. And then it says, kudos to those who see through sickness. And it's this, it's everything, like, it's so much
powerful,
like,
lyrics.
It's life right now, it's our world right
yeah,
now
it is.
I mean, If they decided tomorrow that this was illegal, like, you're not okay, it's not okay to produce this or put this out for anyone to see, or they take away all your microphones and your recording equipment and our wine and everything.
Yeah.
Just be Amish. Don't do anything anymore.
Everything,
like,
that you said, we've lived through all that before too.
And we could again.
Yeah. Well, no, we still do. Where you're talking
about. But
it could
be worse. I mean, they could really, like, they're gonna, you know, if they take guns away, I'm doing it again. God damn it. Because I think it's because I'm Italian. I want to do this. I want to, like, talk with my hands.
He's like, I want to, so, okay, oh, so you know eventually, then we're going to have to get lapel mics or headphone mics. No, seriously, because...
Yeah,
because
I can't handle a hand microphone, clearly.
No, I'm really thinking about that, because to be animated and speak with the hands, it conveys a different message, but I know exactly what you're saying. And then that stand doesn't fit to where your face
is.
Well,
I could put it there, and I would just have to be like this.
I know, but then you would be leaning over.
Yeah.
And that doesn't look very comfortable.
And then I'd be like...
I'm only leaning over because...
Because your back is broken.
Yeah. Oh, but finish, though, because you were going on a roll.
Oh, no, we were talking already about, like, the guns and whatever. Like, everything that, you know, society might see as, like, dangerous or in any way, like, offensive to any group of people. It's like, they just want to shut it off, take it away. Like, let's just not have it anymore. It's like, everybody could pick something that is offensive to them or something that they think is dangerous or whatever. Like, I think bears are dangerous. You know what? Let's not ever be able to go on an Alaskan, like, you know, wilderness journey ever again because bears are dangerous.
Fuck, it's a, like, polar, you know, bear. A polar bear would fuck me up. I'm like running from those.
And I'm saying, you know what? No, that's your choice. Yes, bears are dangerous. Bears are very interesting and cool. Remember to shut my cell phone off when we do this too, but
mute.
You know, like, it's that kind of thing. It's like one small group of people is, like, not okay with something, and they're ready to be like, oh yeah, let's just do away with it. It's not cool. It's not comfortable for everybody. Like, it doesn't have to be comfortable for everybody. That's the beauty of being free. So what if it makes you uncomfortable? Don't have it in your life. That's all.
Yeah. But that's the thing, though, is people want to project their lives on other people.
Everybody, like, are we supposed to all be the same? Because what the fuck is the point of that?
Boredom. Sheer boredom. But I guess it would be cool for, and then we go back to the ruling class, right? We keep going full circle, because we're not really free to do the things that we would want to do, but then when people try to impose what you should be doing for yourself, then that means that you really don't own yourself. You're not the, you know, and that's why I think I wrote it in there too, but that's under the rules of conduct, right? You know, which we'll go over that, but being the authors of our own story, right? And if you're the author of your own story, then that means you have complete authority over what role it is that you want to play in life, right? And right now, we don't have authority over our entire story. You know, that's why you have to ask for permission to do things, right? Because somebody permits you to be able to do this, right? And then you say, please, sir, may I have more?
Please, sir, I'd like some more. Right?
You know, because that's all it is whenever you ask for permission, right? You're asking for permission.
It's funny that, like, I mean, we grow up in a, you know, when you go to school and everything, you have to ask to go to the restroom. It's like, what if they say no? And you're like, but I really have to go.
Yeah, I gotta go to... No, I think I have been saying, well, you gotta wait. When I was younger, they did tell me I have to wait. And it's just, it's a horrible feeling, right?
It's horrible. And also, this is... No, I'm not even gonna tell that story. That was, like, a totally different thing. Because it wasn't like... So I was, like, too shy to ask for permission because I was embarrassed. So, I chose to pee my pants.
You pissed your pants.
I did.
Yeah.
First grade. Yeah. Yep. I was in Brownies.
In Brownies?
Yeah, that's before Girl Scouts.
Oh, yeah.
So, I was like, you know, like, I had to pee, and I was like, oh, I'm scared to ask because what if they say no, or what if, you know, everybody watches me walk to the bathroom. Like, I was just super, like, shy and self-conscious, and so I was like, I guess I'm just going to pee.
Yeah.
So, what's worse? Peeing in your seat, obviously, but...
But then why is that worse? Yeah, it's... No, but that's crazy. You're like, well, fuck it, I'm not going to ask. You were being free at that time. You were like saying...
I was being free.
Yeah.
I didn't really want to, but I did.
It's like, well, you put me in a predicament. Piss myself or ask you if I can go piss.
I don't care what age you are, if you're 5 or if you're, 18 and you're still in high school, you shouldn't really have to ask. Like, if you need to use the restroom, you get up and go. And nobody should be like, where are they going? Who cares?
That's why, and that's why it goes on to, when we go to school, we're not going to learn. We're going to be taught how to be obedient.
We are told that we have to be there for this amount of time every day. Mm-hmm. And it's like, truthfully, if it were more free, if it were like such that you could go to school if you wanted to or if you didn't, whatever, then it wouldn't matter. You wouldn't have to ask to go to the bathroom because you're at school by your own free will. Like,
right.
I'm here to learn. Oh, wait, I have to go to the restroom. Go to the bathroom. Come back. Learn your stuff.
Right.
And it wouldn't even be like a question.
No. But it's funny when you think about it. Like, what's the number one skill that they try to teach you when you're in kindergarten?
Not spilling your thermos on the floor. That was for me.
Yeah. To stand in line.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah.
Conform.
Yeah, stand
always
in line.
Yes.
Right? So the moment that you're able to stand in line, you're right, all the little kids that don't stand in line, little Johnny's not being obedient. I mean, he keeps
a free thinker.
Yeah, he keeps hopping out of line. You might want to.
We're going to have to dub this kid a bad boy.
Yeah.
Like,
and
right now.
What do you get bad boys or bad girls in our world that we live in now? We give them drugs.
Oh.
Yeah, we give them drugs. Well, obviously he needs some. He has ADHD.
Oh, yeah.
Right, yeah, he has ADHD, so therefore, maybe we should go ahead and give him some pills, right? Calm him the fuck down. Yeah, I don't think so. Yeah,
little boys have a lot of testosterone, and that's what recess is good for, running it out.
Yeah, but I think they took that away, though, right? Didn't they take that away?
I don't know.
Yeah,
I hope not. No, they still have recess.
I think that now I'm talking out of my ass, but I know that they've taken out a lot of the little things, like physical education, PE, I don't think is in there anymore.
Ludicrous.
Yeah.
Absolute fucking ludicrous.
But then what does that show you the most?
Oh, well, we'll replace it with a energy suppressing pharmaceutical.
We'll fix
never
that.
Never mind. Yeah, we'll fix that because that's what's wrong with you.
Yeah.
You have energy.
Yeah, you have energy. Let's suppress it.
We want you lethargic.
Yeah.
We want you to just be a lump. That's what we want.
And then people believe that shit. That's the crazy thing to me, right? Is it, and don't get me wrong, I Adderall, I'm fine because it's just a stimulant.
Well, whatever it is. I mean, even if you like to snort Ritalin, because it'll totally fuck you up.
Yeah,
but
that's what I'm saying.
When you're
doing have the choice.
So I don't even know the picture. I shouldn't say it without really knowing it. But it was a picture that I saw online. It was on a social media, and it was like a thing about like Oxycontin versus something else. Like
heroin.
Pot or something.
No,
I don't know.
Yeah.
Well, yeah, so it said Oxycontin is like generic heroin for, a kid.
That's all it is.
Versus whatever the other thing was they were comparing it to, which is, some kind of a plant type thing. And it's like
poppy seed.
One's okay for whatever reason. Yeah, poppy seed. It's opioids, right?
Yeah.
Like one's okay because the FDA says so, and the other's not okay because the FDA doesn't approve it.
Yeah, but then this is what's crazy.
And one's a pill, it's a chemical, and one's a plant.
Which is still a chemical. If you break it down at the molecular.
It's not synthesized in a lab. I can't remember, I don't know what the other, I don't think it was pot, I think it was something else.
No, if they're talking about Oxy, right, or Percocet or anything like that.
It was Oxycontin, for sure.
Right, then of course they're going to immediately infer to poppy seed, because that's its point of origin.
Okay.
Right, so poppy seed.
I have it on my phone somewhere.
Yeah, you can totally take poppy seeds and make a tea.
Yeah.
It'll numb you out.
My dad used to make, tea because we used to grow poppies in our yard. So he would clip all the, after the petals fell off, he would clip
all the
things. I think
your dad, he sounds very interesting.
If he wasn't so fucked up, he was actually fucking brilliant.
Yeah.
I mean, I miss the guy like crazy because he actually like was just too smart for his own good, but he didn't know it. He knew he was smart, but he didn't know how good he was.
Mm-hmm.
But he was always doing, experimental kind of stuff like that. But, yeah, so, I mean, I remember, and it wasn't weird to me. Like, I knew my dad made opium tea, and I didn't know that was, like, not okay. It was like, he clipped flowers from the backyard, he did whatever he did with it, and steeped it and drank it, and he was totally happy.
Yeah.
And I think it was actually what really messed him up was he got addicted to painkillers, and then he started just, he went off the edge, but, actually it wasn't that, it was something else, but either way, I mean, that's totally like a natural thing that you can do in any way. Like you said, poppy seeds.
Yeah.
You can go buy a bagel, scrape poppy seeds off of it, and just do whatever you want with it.
Isn't that crazy though?
Yeah.
It grows totally out there. It grows out there in nature, and they say
that's not okay.
Bitch,
you
can't
absolutely
do that.
Not. You'll fail a drug test if you eat a poppy seed bagel before a fucking interview.
I know, right?
So crazy.
Yeah.
And you're like, I mean, I'd be like, I've never done drugs in my life.
Yeah.
And I'd be totally honest, and they'd be like, no, sorry.
Yeah.
Like, oh,
pop for heroin, bitch.
Yeah.
I have no track lines
in my
arms. Yeah. You can even check between my toes. Don't ask me how I know that.
Is that a thing?
Yeah, well, you can inject between the webs.
Oh, that sounds terrible.
Yeah, but no, but this is what's so crazy. I think it's crazy, but brilliant, too, is how genius the human mind is.
They'll find a way around it.
We'll always find a fucking way.
Always.
Always, right? You know, every time that you prohibit, you know, or prohibit means you're stopping people from thinking a certain way, we will find a fucking way, right? And I think that's a beautiful quality of our species. Right, is it?
It's very innovative. I mean, there's like,
hell yeah.
We're just like, there's nothing I'm not going to figure out. We're going to do it.
Yeah. It was like, oh, you're
That's
telling
why
me
we're flying, you know, how much does an airplane weigh?
Oh, I don't know.
A billion tons? No, I mean, I'm serious. Like, it's a heavy hunk of metal.
Yeah.
We fly that stuff all over the world.
Exactly.
That's crazy.
Yeah. You know
when
what?
You think about it.
It is.
I mean,
totally.
I'm very thankful for it.
Yeah.
I don't even like flying, but...
No, but it does.
It's amazing.
I know. That's a whole other topic where you see how planes...
Because it's just like, it just seems like you're defying everything. Like...
Defying how?
Defying physics. I mean, to have this huge, heavy object filled with many, many people. I mean, you're... I guess...
No, it's because we understand physics is why we're able to.
Yeah, you're right. Yeah. No, you're right. Get it going to a certain speed and hit it at a certain angle and you'll be up, you know, but it's amazing. It blows my mind.
What's crazy about that is that we can all think a bicycle. Because the reason why we have planes in the sky right now is all because of a fucking bicycle. So,
well, because somebody invented the wheel and it changed the entire world.
The wheel itself.
That's all it was.
Just that little circular
Without
thing.
Without the wheel, we wouldn't be here.
Ah. Yeah, well, there's lots of things we wouldn't be here if it wasn't for.
Most important invention ever in the history of mankind, though.
No.
Yes.
Fire.
That's not an invention. That's a discovery.
No, but we've invented how to reproduce it, right?
Yes.
Yes, we invented how to reproduce it at will. So fire, and this is...
Yeah, we don't have to rub sticks together. We can just go...
Yeah, but no, just the fact that we even found out that friction... or rubbing sticks together would cause a spark in order for us to get fire from something that we just saw that used to come from the gods, right? You know, so depending on what culture
Praying
you came from.
Praying to the fire
from,
god.
You know.
Doesn't sound like it would be a very lucrative...
Fuck no, that shit would be boring as hell, right?
Yeah.
You know, you have to wait for lightning to strike. Fire, bitch!
Oh my
right?
god.
And then you'd run after it. But,
and then you'd be a god. Like, oh my god, it happened for you.
Yeah, yeah, you know, just imagine all the people that would hide it, you know, that they knew how to start fire. Right,
mm-hmm.
And then it would come out, and people would worship them.
Mm-hmm.
Oh my God, look at how badass you are! But fire though, because it allows it starts the digestive process of our food.
Yes.
Right, and mm-hmm. it also protects us.
Yes, absolutely.
Yeah, you know, so it's a
in
tool.
In many ways.
It's a tool that just enhanced us in so many ways that we wouldn't even be here maybe if it wasn't for fire. And that's a whole nother shit. That we can wrap our heads around on another time.
Right. So many topics.
Yeah. No, but that's why this intro is super good. Because we're laying out now. So now we got the what, why, how. And then now we'll just break down the rules.
This is my favorite section.
The rules of conduct?
Because I like the first point. I like the first bullet point out of everything else. Because it speaks to me.
Yes. Okay, so the rules of conduct. This is how they roll out on Mind Slut. Don't feel intimidated because you don't feel you have the qualifications to share. Don't feel you have to be an authority in a topic shared. We can only be the authority figures in our own lives. And we are the authors of our own story.
We are the authors of our own story.
I like that. Use simple, basic English. Your voice sounds really good when you put it up.
When I pretend I'm sexy.
Yeah, it's like the frequency just like shot through my brain, like wow. And then I was like, what? I looked up like a dog like this. She was like, we are there.
Like I could say something really stupid, like
ow.
I don't know.
Ow. Baba Ghanoush. I hope I didn't offend anybody when I said baba ghanoush, because that's the food.
I don't know what that
it's
is.
It's like an eggplant. It's an eggplant.
I feel like it's Jewish. Is it Jewish?
No. Oh. It's not Jewish, but it is Middle Eastern, and I'm brain farting on where. It's over around your way. You can go get it, the baba ghanoush, because it's like made from eggplant or whatever.
Oh, really?
Yeah, I'll look it up.
Eggplant. I like this bottle.
The bottle? It is kind of sexy.
Juliet. I like the name, too.
So, baba ghanoush. Let's find out what that fucking word means.
Baba ghanoush.
Will you go look it up?
It reminds me of Borat. That's what it's different.
Baba ghanoush. Okay, Google. Define baba ghanoush.
Baba ghanoush, a thick sauce or spread made from ground eggplant and sesame seeds, olive oil, lemon, and garlic, typical of Eastern Mediterranean cuisine.
Bam. Gotcha, bitch.
You had it. Yeah. Come on, I think it's Jewish.
Yeah, I think it's Jewish.
Can you edit that part out?
No way, because the Jewish part is brilliant.
Oh, that's right. Funny.
Yeah. So yeah, you like the first one though, right?
I love the first one.
Yeah.
Because, well, perfect example. I think it's Jewish. I just made that shit up. Sounded Jewish to me. Because, I mean, what does it mean to have qualifications? I mean, we're not like...
There it is. What does a qualification
so
even mean?
So, some, like, we don't have a curriculum. We don't have a, you know... specific, like, guidelines. So what's, I mean, to be qualified in something.
Well, no, but we did, like, we're laying out the guidelines for what it is that we're creating, right? So these are our guidelines, and that's all you do. So we're qualifying, we can self-qualify, right? Because all we're doing is sharing the ideas and topics.
Yeah,
so
it's opinions, mostly.
Well, everything is an opinion, but then the opinions that we can share, we can easily fact-check them. Right, and this is the difference between the world that we live in now and in the world that people grew up in from back in the day. Right, so if somebody says something, you can easily fact check that shit and be like, you know what, bro?
And have it in less than 5 seconds.
Yeah, you might be full of bullshit. Right, so then now what Mind Slut is all about is synthesizing all these ideas. How can we mesh whatever it is out there and together? And since we're just regular old people,
mm-hmm.
right, you know, and if we can do it because we drive cars, right? And if we can do it, then maybe we can all do it. But then, you know.
It's amazing we're allowed to do that too, by the way.
What's that?
Drive cars.
It is.
Drive anything. Drive a U-Haul truck.
Yeah,
that was the most terrifying experience.
I know, right? Beep, beep,
so
beep.
Terrifying.
But yeah, get your ass to work, bitch. Which is why we can all drive cars.
Yeah.
Right, so we can get to where we need to do the work. But yeah, you know, so qualifications, like what you were saying, you know, to say that somebody qualifies to say something, you're basically saying that they're an expert in whatever field that it is they might be in. But then to be an expert just means that you might know all the little minutia regarding all the stuff. But if you can understand a concept of something, then you can easily break it down.
Yeah, and what's cool is, like, it's not like you're trying to prove anything. Like, when you have, like, a resume and you go to apply for a job, you list your qualifications. You're like, okay, here's how I can prove to you that I'm worthy of, you know, whatever it is we're going to do here, mm-hmm. whether it's, you know, working at the hospital or anything.
Wherever.
It's like, I can do this, I've done that, and, like, you're at the mercy of people to either believe you or, you know, fact check or not, you know, because that's why you have references.
That's what I liked how the military referred to it as.
How do they do it?
This was another life because I was once in the Navy. Right? But in the Navy, throughout the year, we had to fill out a brag sheet.
Brag sheet.
Like you're bragging.
Like you're bragging about yourself? All,
yeah. So basically you're writing down all the cool shit
that's
that you do.
That's what it should be.
That's what the fuck it is. Right? You know, so whenever you see qualifications, insert brag. What are you bragging about? What did you do?
Sure.
Right? You know, because that's all you're doing. You're just bragging about, well, I did this and I did that.
Totally. And if you, yeah. I mean, if you're like, if you're a wordsmith and you can just manipulate your little, you know, statements to just sound really good,
yeah,
you might have the exact same experiences, qualifications as the next guy, but if you have written it in such a way that makes you sound intelligent or whatever, you've got the job.
Yeah.
And it's like you have the exact same qualifications.
Yeah.
It's funny.
You see how poetic it sounds when that individual wrote down that, you know, they are able to organize people in a specific way in order to influence them to do such and such things, right? How many different ways can you say that?
You could say, for example, like, okay, I apply for a job somewhere and I say, well, I worked with the neuro team. I did a lot of brain surgery. Or you could say, I was part of a neuro team. I specialized in cerebrovascular, you know, such and such. And I mean, you could just manipulate it in any little way to make it sound like, wow, okay, she did something really cool.
Yeah.
She did something big or whatever.
Yeah.
So, I don't know. It's interesting, though,
But this goes on the jargon that you're talking about.
I like the brag sheet, though.
Right? Super simple, straightforward. I'm basically bragging
and
about
And that's what
me.
A resume is. You're bragging. That's all it is. Brag sheet. That's brilliant.
I did this, I did that, I did this, and this year I did this, this, and that, and that year I did this, this, and that. Ah, and then what did you accomplish? Well, you know, I'm going to tell you some more, bitch. This, this, and that, yada, 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 blah, blah, blah. That's why now when you see people and they want resumes or they want things, people sometimes are sending them straight to their website. Right? They're saying, check out my website. Check out this shit. Check. Dropped it. Right? You know, they're like.
Dropped it.
They're like, check out this shit. Check out that. Right? You know, look at what I built. Look at what I created. How is that relevant to what it is that you're going to do? It's not, but I did that shit, right? What did you do? So.
But do you think it's funny how we've become so, and I don't know if this is even a good word, but for lack of a better word, like the narcissism of like the younger generations, just because of like social media, I would say. Like, I mean, for the original thing for me was MySpace. I mean, you build this page, you put your pictures on there, like, here's what I think, what I feel, what I blah, blah, blah. And it's like, it's only just so original because they give you a template and you just fill it in, you know? But we all think that we're very, you know, special and individual and whatever. And
well, we are.
Right. But I just wonder, like, I mean, we're taking something that somebody else has created for us and we're filling it all in and saying, like, look how original I am. Like, we didn't really create that. We're just, anybody can jump on there and do that.
Yeah, they can do it. But the thing, and this is where I think that a lot of people might misunderstand, and that's including a lot of businesses or corporations, is that you are doing nothing but just creating a platform.
Mm-hmm.
So MySpace is nothing but a platform for people to communicate on, right? Facebook is nothing but a platform for people to communicate on. All the little tricks and shit that you're doing on there, yeah, that's just bells and whistles or whatever, but all you're doing is just you're providing a conduit for people to communicate on. So then when we get caught up, because I was on that too, about like, you know, like I hated the bloatware on MySpace and when you can put sparkles.
I love that trick. Oh my God, that's what I wish Facebook had. I want like the sparkly background and the lightning bolts and all the stupid shit that I had.
No, but you can do that now. You can do that now on your main picture. I think on the upper part on your Facebook, you can put a background image in there.
Okay.
To reflect something or whatever it is. That's all you want to do. You just want to distinguish yourself from everybody else. And then MySpace lost it because their code was so shitty. Because then stuff would take forever to load up.
Is that what it was? Yeah. I always wondered, like, why did Facebook take over?
Oh, it was simple.
My favorite thing about MySpace was that you could have a song playing on your profile. Ah, that was my favorite thing.
I remember that.
I had, oh my God, it was the best feature. I loved it because I was like, okay, well, I'm a music junkie, so my most favorite thing is music. Hmm. I can have a song playing that reflects who I am and how I feel at this point in my life. Perfect. And that was awesome. Mm. And I think actually now, somebody told me that MySpace is now only a musical platform.
Well,
only bands have MySpace now.
No, a lot of them do. But yeah, it is primarily geared towards...
Like, I can't go on MySpace and like create a profile anymore?
Yeah, you can.
Oh, I can.
Your profile is probably still there.
Yeah, I don't know how to get into it anymore.
Do you remember the email address that you used?
Nope, because I don't have it anymore.
Just hop on there and look for your name.
I have two old MySpace profiles from
a very long time ago. You totally got to find it.
I want to find it so bad.
You totally got to find it.
But I don't know if I want to find it, actually.
It was like, I remember my first website that I ever created was a GeoCity. GeoCity for a GeoSite. And this was with Yahoo. And they closed that a while ago.
Okay.
Right? This was like in 99, 2000.
Yeah.
Right? And it was just like what you see is what you get. You just like drag and drop shit.
Yep.
Into there. And that was my...
So awesome. That was like prime time, though, for the internet. Like, everything exploded during that time.
Oh, my God. Like... I remember it because I was so proud. I was so proud of this shit.
You were bragging on that?
Yeah, I was like... Yeah, bitch. I got a website.
On your brag sheet, you had like a go-to... whatever it was, .com.
Yeah, no. It wasn't .com. It was GeoCities. It was, you had the / GeoCities, right? So you felt it in their container, right?
Because
it was all Yahoo. They killed it. They killed it or whatever. But it was just very interesting because I remember, like, I would be up late, you know, just trying to you know, make my little Geo site look decent. And it was very bad. The more that I think about it, I need to go find that shit too.
I wish I knew how to find that stuff. I don't think I would
The Internet Archive. We can probably find it on the Internet Archive. But your MySpace, that's still there. It's still there. Yahoo still sends me messages telling me about MySpace.
Oh, my
God. Because of their revamp, right, with the music and stuff like that. So it would probably be interesting to hop back on there and check it out. And see.
That's so cool.
You can probably find lots of, you know, of course, lots of bands and things like that. But
yeah.
Then you have SoundCloud.
I know. That's what I'm like, why is it still relevant? Because there's so many new, like, better technology now, like, music-wise. I mean.
Yeah, it's all relevant. It's just another space. And then there's, I forgot how many billions, 7? Whatever. It's either 7 or 9 billion people. I'm not even going to look it up because I'm too lazy right now.
Too lazy. But, you know, typical American. Yeah. No,
there's, there's anywhere between 7 to 9 billion people in this world right now. Right?
Yeah.
Which means there's a lot of space for people to go on MySpace, Facebook, Google, Instagram, Twitter. Right? We can just keep hopping down these social networks over and over and over. So there's more than enough people in the world for them to aggregate to all these spots. This is something that sort of kind of annoys me about the tech industry, is how they try to, well, I guess with everything, they try to aggregate everybody into certain silos. You know, are you Facebook? Are you Google Plus?
Yeah.
Right. Are you Apple? Are you Android?
Yeah, exactly.
Right? You know, oh, no, bitch. I'm using Windows. Oh, you use Windows still.
You're right? Like a leper. Like, oh,
right?
Windows?
You know, you're like, fuck you. You know? But it's like my device, you know, and I pulled it out, and you're like, oh, what's that? Is that an iPhone? I'm like, no, it's a Huawei. Who?
I would have no idea.
I was like, no, it's a Huawei phone. It's a Chinese manufacturer. It's only the number 3 biggest mobile device company in the world. I don't know about that. No fucking right. You're an American, right? You have no clue. Your two devices are Apple and Samsung.
Guilty.
Right. Right. What is yours?
It's an Apple.
Yeah. You know, so
everybody's, it's the,
like,
only smartphone I've ever had. So it's what I'm comfortable with.
Yeah. And
I love it.
I remember you talking about that.
Yeah, because I was so opposed to it for so long. I was like, I'm not, I was like my grandmother at like age 25. I'm like, I'm just going to have my flip phone and I'm just going to live under a rock.
Yeah.
And then finally, like, I was like, all right, I guess I got to join this century and get on it. Mm-hmm. And I'm so happy that I did.
Yeah.
I still try to, like, somewhat keep up with, like, technology and what's going on in the world, but I find myself just, like, I feel like I'm always the last to know. Like, I'm, like, old, stuck in a young person's body somehow.
She's like, I'm the last to know.
I feel like that.
Well, shit. I was going to say, do you hang out with old people?
Sometimes.
That could be one of the reasons why.
Not as of late.
Yeah.
But, I feel like, I don't know why, like, I've always just felt like I, could relate better to older people. I don't even know why.
Well, because they're older. They have a little bit more wisdom. They can share with you the different life experiences.
Yeah, and I mean, even, like, for myself, like, my activities that I like to do, I like to, like, number one thing I like to do is hiking or, you know, anything outdoors. Like, I'd rather do that than go to, like, out to the bars, you know.
Ah, yeah, yeah.
And so I would just always kind of fall into the older crowd of people.
Dude, I hike. So are you saying
do you hike?
Old? Yeah.
I didn't know that.
Yeah.
Not right now, because your back's broken, but when your back's not broken.
Yeah. But yeah, like swim. Swim and I, we used to hike all the time. And we would go do, I'm brain farting on the name.
Drugs?
No, not drugs. the peak. It's north, and I forgot the name of it.
Iron Mountain?
Yeah, Iron Mountain.
Or Mount Woodson?
Either
one. Woodson's the tough one.
Yeah, but Iron Mountain and then go all up around there.
I just did
there.
Iron Mountain on Monday.
Oh, you did?
Or Tuesday.
Yeah.
No, Monday I did, yeah.
Yeah, and then the other one, that one is up north too, and I forgot, but it has the peak that you would go out there. And
that potato chip?
Yeah, potato
That's
chip.
That's Mount Woodson. That's right across from Iron Mountain.
Yeah. Those, and, you know, those are pretty fun ones, but I know that the people that I went with sometimes, they weren't, it was a different type of hike.
Different type of hike.
Yeah,
okay, got it.
It was a different. It was a different type of hike, but it was fun.
Yeah.
Just going up there and then checking out the people, but yeah, fucking hiking. It's
anything
fun.
Like, and I love both of those hikes for for convenience because they're not very far away, but they feel like they're out there.
Yeah.
But anything like I love backpacking, hiking, anything that's kind of just far away, where you can just be. Without stuff, like it's almost because you are forced to be disconnected. You don't really have cell phone service. You don't really have, you know, TVs or anything. So it's like, what do people do without the conveniences that we? I don't even think about it. Like I come home from work sometimes, and I'll go and like you know grab a snack and a drink, turn on my TV, and I just sit there like a vegetable. And like,
after you hike.
No, like, from work. I'm just saying, like,
okay.
You know, the conveniences that we have that...
Yeah, we don't earn it.
Don't earn it. And don't even think about it while we're doing it. I'm just, like, literally, like, a vegetable in front of the TV, like... And it's you're forced to not have... I mean, you don't have that when you're out, like,
in
somewhere
nature.
Where you can't have that. Like, camping. If you camp, or if you're out in Joshua Tree or Anza Borrego, which is where I'm trying to get a hiking thing going out there.
When are you trying to do that?
Sometime this month. I'm on call this weekend, so not this weekend.
Well, let me know when.
I'll let you know.
I'll go out there.
For sure. I'm trying to get, like, you know, a date. And it might just even be, like, a one-night thing. I don't know. Because I only have a small tent, a couple sleeping bags.
And you want to camp out there?
I want to camp.
Oh, shitness. Yeah, I'm totally down.
Oh, shitness.
Because then we can have, I could have some substances out there.
You could have substances,
yeah, so I can actually look up at the stars.
Absolutely.
Because,
and that's what I want.
Yeah.
I want connection to, like, other, the other side of things.
You want to be a complete person.
And that's the only time it happens.
Was when you go out into the wild and you let your hair down and your
flag
flow and you're like, yeah.
Exactly. Yeah, like jumping from rock to rock and like, like.
Yeah. And he's like, this is me when I was a billy goat.
Yep.
Meh.
So funny.
Right? Now watch me. I'm going to pretend to be a rattlesnake. Right?
That's so scary.
Here's my scorpion stance. That I'm just stealing from all the kung fu shows and shit.
I'm scared of scorpions. Yeah. I've never seen one.
Oh.
Have you seen them here?
No, I haven't actually.
Really? Because apparently they're here.
Yeah,
I've just
they
never
are.
Seen one.
I'm trying to remember if there was one. I remember watching a documentary about the ones that were basically like albino.
If I ever see one, though, I'm going to catch it and keep it.
Oh, really? Why? Just go get one for a pet.
No.
It's not crazy we have pets.
Yeah. Like, well, I'm saying, like, rather than smush it because I'm scared, like,
yeah.
I'll probably... Because you, like... Like, if I get a spider in my house, I usually just scoop it up in a cup and I throw it outside. It
yeah.
probably comes back in,
yeah.
you know?
Oh, my God.
But if I see a scorpion, I'm just going to catch it.
My ex, she was fucking petrified of all bugs,
really?
All insects. She would freak the fuck out. She would go, ee! Right? And then, you know, just like...
There's a lot of bugs that I don't like.
Yeah, but then they're just...
They're just bugs. I know. And
yeah.
I try to... So that's why I have a love of spiders now, because there's so many other bugs that I hate. When I had this cockroach issue at my last house, the reason that I moved.
Yeah.
That's why I'm like, okay, I will take spiders over cockroaches any day. I have a spider that lives in my shower with me. And that probably sounds ridiculous, but
not
it's
really.
Like in the window, it made a little web, and I'm like, you know, it's only ever right there, it doesn't move.
Mm-hmm.
I'm just gonna leave it there, because if any other bugs come in the window, he can just have them.
Lunch, so, bitches.
We have a friendship, and it works.
Totally.
But if they're crawling around on my floor, like, I scoop them up and I throw them outside. But
get outside, bitch, now.
Outside, for sure.
Project.
We went on like a weird tangent there, and I don't remember what we were talking about.
Oh,
before.
Yeah, because we were talking about the rules of conduct, right? And we were talking about qualifications.
The qualifications,
yeah.
That, yeah.
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah. So yeah, you just gone full circle. So, did I don't know if we mentioned this about don't feel you have to be an authority in the topic shared. Right?
I always feel like you're the authority because you always come up with everything.
No.
You're like, we need to talk about this.
No.
And then I'm like, yeah, I don't ever come up with anything. So I feel like that's where it's like almost like, well, I don't even know if I can talk about that. But that's why I like the first bullet point.
Yeah.
I don't necessarily have to be qualified, so to speak.
None of us are. Yeah. Because they're just interesting things.
Well, if none of us are, then we all are.
We are. And this
so,
is the dirty little secret they don't want you to know. Right? Is that we all have the ability.
It's just not on paper. It's not on a degree with a gold plating.
Oh, yes. Now you're talking about a completely other track. Right? Yeah, that's something totally different. Because, yeah, who's to say that you can't attain the same information? Because all it is
just
information.
That reminds me of this movie. Did you ever watch Catch Me If You Can?
Ah, yeah, I remember it. Yeah.
So, Leonardo DiCaprio, and it's based on a true story, which is even better. And I was just talking about this with somebody the other day, because it's a fucking awesome movie.
Mm.
And, you know, all the things that he did and, like, pretended that he was, you know, whether it was a pilot or a lawyer or a doctor. And he, like, fabricated all these degrees or, you know, qualification.
Right.
All the documentation he fabricated. And also, like, he, like, passed the bar. Like, he could have very well been a lawyer.
Mm-hmm.
Never went to school, but the guy was obviously super smart. So, it's funny because... I never went to law school, but what if I went and took the bar, you know?
Yeah.
State of California and, like, passed it. Am I a lawyer?
Well,
basically.
Technically, yeah, you could.
Yeah.
Be. But that's what's so interesting about it is that everything that it is that we study or learn or do, it's just information.
Mm-hmm.
And then all it has to do is with, well, do you understand the information? And can you synthesize it in the manner that it needs to be? There's nothing difficult about it, right? And this is why...
We make it pretty damn difficult. And I think we overthink it more often than not. Because I tend to do that with
Explain.
Anything.
Give me
everything.
An example.
I
can't even do that.
Apparently I'm a horse.
Yeah.
I don't know. I don't know that I have a specific example. But, like, I overthink everything. Like, if I knew what we were going to talk about today, I probably would have, like, been like... Shit, I gotta look this up. I gotta know what I'm talking about. Like, I would have probably, like, stressed about it even,
yeah.
Like, and looked up things and topics, and, like, I had no idea what we were gonna get into today.
Yeah.
And it's better that way, because it's organic. But
I don't
anything
know why
like that
like, popped in my head too.
Organic.
Yeah.
Anything all the time, you know, if I just, you know, I'm thinking about it like, oh my God, you know, I'm overthinking it.
No, you're just thinking about it. That's
yeah,
all you're doing.
Maybe.
Yeah, you're just thinking about it. And then.
But I think if you think about it too much and if you try to prepare too much, I mean, because, I don't know, maybe it's because I would, like, be nervous about it or something, that, like, it wouldn't happen in the way that it's happening now. It wouldn't be...
Yeah.
It wouldn't
I
be
see.
Organic.
Yeah.
I would have had it planned out, and I
yeah.
might have said different things than I'm saying now.
Well, that would be the second part of the... of, you know, when we talk about thought experiments.
Yeah.
The thought experiments would...
I think we have talked about this once before, too, actually. Like, planning talks and then just doing talks, like,
yeah.
organically.
Yeah. Well, all of them are going to function in our organic fashion. But from the talks, I'm going to pull things from them, right? Like, some of the discussions that we've even had today, you know, like, say, you know, in the show notes section of the podcast, where now you can go and you can find this source or that source, or you can do this or you can do that, or here's the section where we were talking about the Borrego Springs,
mm-hmm.
and you know, and if you wanted to go out there and you go for a hike, well, this is how you can set that up. But then, you know, it could just be all sorts of informative things, and that will be the thought experiment portion of it.
Okay.
Right? Conversation. How can you instigate a fun, good, decent conversation? And that's what we were talking about when we were saying at the bar. When you go into the bar scene,
uh-huh.
and then all you're doing is just asking, hey, I just want to say hi. And then somebody gives you shit, like, yeah, not to me, or something
yeah,
like that.
Sure.
You know, so.
Well, that kind of brings me to another point. Like, what, so in that situation when that happens, like, you see somebody at the bar, and you decide, I'm going to approach them. Is it because you are attracted to them and you want, like, something?
Yes. It's always.
So, you know, there are other people at the bar that you wouldn't probably approach, right? Like, you have, like, a target. You're like, okay, that's the one I'm going to talk to.
Well, yeah, you could say that. Yeah, but it always depends on.
I'm just wondering because I've never been I mean, oh, God.
Sorry. Yeah, okay. Kicked the table. Yeah. Well, and then I'll just speak only for myself, is because when you see someone,
mm-hmm.
the initial reason why you see them is because there's something that attracts
physically.
You.
Physically.
Yeah. You
more
know,
than likely.
Yeah. So first it's that physical,
sure.
that physical aspect. And then you can say, okay, well now I'm going to go and I want to say something, right? And now you want to see, at one level you have the physical connection.
Mm-hmm.
Second level, you're going to go into the intellectual
mm-hmm.
Connection. Hello. Right? You know, so yeah. So if somebody responds to you like that,
oh
then all of a sudden, all attraction just stops. Right? Yeah. And then it just shuts down.
Oh,
right? Because
so funny.
Because you're like, oh my God, I can't even talk to you.
Yeah.
Right? And but then some people will be like, well, I don't give a fuck. I just want to see what this person is like in a different scenario or a different situation. And that's just being, you know, that could just be totally sexual or whatever, right? But then, you know, there's like all these different levels. But I know for me, that would be the hop. It would first be physical, and then it would be intellectual, right? Because I know the physical aspect wears off super quick,
mm-hmm.
you know, because then I can see that with the way that you might be thinking that you're a very ugly person, right? And I would immediately see that, right? Like you think that people... should be like this and that, which means that you aren't very open, you don't empathize with people,
sure.
or you don't do that, which means that you're now I'm no longer looking at you in the way that I first initially looked at you, and then my whole perspective has changed. But then that would be my hop.
Okay.
My hop process when I'm in even though I haven't done it in a very long time, but just regardless, right? If I'm interested in somebody and I go in and I speak to them, then that's my brain. That's my logical process.
Okay.
You know, physical first, intellectual second.
Because that's what's going to last.
Yeah. Yeah.
So even though, like, the initial thing is the first thing, like, it's not necessarily the most important thing?
Yes and no. Because the physical part is, because that's
it
also
is important.
Yeah,
absolutely.
It's an external representation of how you think about yourself,
mm-hmm.
right? So if you're running around and you're looking a specific way, you don't care about the way that it is that you look, then I want to know, well, why do you think like that,
mm-hmm.
right? And then if you think in that way because you really don't care because you're just a free spirit and you're just running around doing this, I can think that that's a beautiful thing,
yeah.
right? But then if you're doing it and then you're saying, well, I'm trying to do this or I'm trying to do that, then that to me can indicate that there might be some flaw in your thinking,
mm-hmm.
right? And then I would go on a whole nother tangent on just that, on that realm right there.
Yeah.
What are you thinking?
Oh no, I'm just listening.
I saw your eyes go up and to the left, which means that you were pulling back from a memory.
Oh, I don't know if I was.
Hmm. Okay.
Feeling a little bit good right now.
Ah, yes. See, and that's
why. Might have just been that.
And that's why the substances. That's why the substances are good, but yeah, I know that.
I feel almost like deja vu right now because I'm thinking back to the last time we did this, and I feel like that happened last time.
You had deja vu?
I feel like you were like, what are you thinking? And I was like, I don't know, I feel kind of drunk. That's what I'm remembering right now. Like, I think that's the same exact thing that happened.
Yes, you said that when we were driving.
I did not say that. Because I was driving. That's not what happened.
She's like, I might be a little drunk.
I might be drunk.
Yeah, and she's driving the car.
Oh, God.
Yeah, that was so funny. Yeah, but why? What about you? When somebody...
I don't know. Well, and it's a little bit different for me because I feel like I'm usually on on the prey side of things, not the predator side of things.
Mm.
So usually somebody will like approach me that, you know, and I usually will give anybody the time of day. Like I'm never like, get away from me. And I'll talk to anybody. But I mean, I agree with you that, you know, physically, like, there has to be something to, you know, for it to continue beyond that little meeting, you know, at the bar or wherever it is. So,
I saw the bar.
But I think what's Ace of Base, my first favorite band ever. I'd like to think, and I might just be saying this, I'd like to think that, the intellectual portion is like a lot more important than a physical attraction, because someday when you're both old and gross, like, you're both gonna be gross, but you'll still kind of have, you'll be the
something
the people.
To share.
I mean, I don't want to say that you'll be the same people
yeah.
that you were back then, because you won't be, but you've both grown together, so in a sense you are the same people.
Yeah.
That, you know, and that should be ultimately what matters. But
how you morph into something like that.
Morph.
Same creatures.
Mm.
Yeah. Fun. Look at that. We hopped all over the place.
Slut.
Yeah.
Mind slut.
Okay. So now, we're down to the last two on the rules of conduct. We can only be the authority figures in our own lives. Some powerful shit.
And I agree 100%. And I don't know where that came from in your mind.
You're the master of your own story, is what it boils down to. Right, is that you are the author, and that's why the second part came.
Well, it makes me think back to what we talked about just a while ago, where like you said that like at a young age you were thinking differently, you know, about where you were going, and you were just, you had a different mindset at a young age than most people have, and I feel like I kind of did too, and
I think we all did.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah.
So, I think that's where it starts, being the master of your own story, or whatever it is.
Yeah.
The author of your own story, I should say.
But then that's why, what I don't think a lot of people do. They are not the masters of their own story.
Maybe they fail to acknowledge it. And it's not that they aren't, but they just don't think about it.
Yes, you're right. Because, and this is why I steal this line all the time from one of my digital mentors. which would let you know my mind frame on a lot of things. Terrence McKenna.
Terrence McKenna.
Yeah.
Okay. I know the name.
Yeah. Where he says culture is not your friend. Right, and that's something that it sits and it resonates with me in such a profound way, because I was not brought up in any specific culture, right? So therefore, I'm able to look outside the box and then see how culture binds you into a specific way of thinking, right? Which means that culture can give a fuck about who you are as long as you listen or you obey to whatever culture tells you. And that's why those words that he said, when he said culture is not your friend, it doesn't respect you, right?
It's not going to let you be who you would be. Mm-hmm. It's going to tell you who you're going to be.
Yeah, it says, no, bitch. If you're part of this culture,
here's who you are.
Boom, you go like that, right? And, yeah, I don't think that that's who we are.
I just had, like, a weird picture pop in my head when you said that, like, a bunch of people standing in line taking tickets, like, here's who you are. Somebody's handing out,
you know. You get this ticket, you get that
ticket. This is you.
Yeah.
This is your life. Whatever, yeah, like, if I were, like, a good artist, I could totally, like, portray that, like, in a drawing or something.
Did it with words.
Yeah, but that's what I'm thinking. Like, that's what popped in my head, literally, when you said that. Like, wow, that's kind of fucked up.
It is, right? You know, but...
So much for being free.
Yeah, you can say, no, it is, Photo by Leslie Manlove. What kind of name? Leslie Manlove.
And Leslie, it could be a man or a woman.
I know.
I don't even know who that is.
I know. But G. Leslie Manlove, right? Yeah. Oh, man. Yeah, so that's the second part. Don't feel you have to be an authority in the topic shared. And, oh, no, I already said that. But the last part.
Use basic English. That's the...
It's key.
And that's, like, the most basic, simple part of this whole thing.
Mm-hmm. It's key.
Yeah.
Yeah. Basic English, when we're describing things that in our minds could be super complex. Mm. You know, like, how do social networks work?
How do they work?
Yes. You know, basically, I tell you something. Oh, we have a social network. Right. Can you help me out? Oh, yeah. Do you know anybody that can help me out? Oh, yeah. Oh, shit. We just created a social network. Right, yeah.
This is the social network that is Mind Slut.
Yeah.
This is a different kind of social network.
Yeah, but it's still a social network. But then just using basic language, so then that way everybody can communicate on the same plane. Right? Mm-hmm. Because who was it? Yeah, that's one of the biggest things that aggravates me about professional journals. When you read them. Right? And of course, yes, you know, you have to have specific jargon, because it's precise for that specific area right there, right? But then when they talk about like quantum entanglements, right? Quantum particles and things like that, right? Okay, yeah, you can say that, but now give me an example.
Break it down, so that anybody could read that
exactly
and understand
it. Build an anchor so I can link. Your quantum
entanglement. But they wall it off, so it's like, oh, only if you're of a certain, not even intelligence, but like education level, that you can read this. Because it really doesn't come down to intelligence, but it comes down to like what you've been educated on.
Yeah.
Like,
do you have the vocabulary?
Do you have the vocabulary? Yeah. And if you don't, then, well, you're an idiot, apparently.
Oh, you
have no brain.
Yeah, you don't understand this? That's to be you. Yeah, I'm so sorry.
You can go sit at the little kid table.
Yeah, you know, instead of somebody saying, well, let me figure out how I can build a bridge, right? And that's probably one of the biggest things that I think that I would like for us to do is build bridges. Build bridges, you know, from topic to topic about shit. You know, it's a lot of shit that I might not understand, but I want to understand.
Mm-hmm.
So then, therefore, it's going to motivate me in order to learn about it. And then once I learn about it, I want to fucking talk about it and then share it with you, and then just rant and then see what it is that you can say, and then you can bounce shit off of my head, and then I'm just like, oh my god, I was like, I never thought about it like that. But then, you know, you can just have all sorts of different things just percolate from you know, if you use basic language.
That's what makes this so great, because it's just, it kind of spirals. Like, it starts out with like one idea that we might have, mm-hmm. that we're going to talk about.
Yeah.
And then it's like, bing, bing, bing. Like, after 30 minutes, we've gone on like 12 different tangents. Like, okay, we have so many things we need to talk about now.
But do you know what's crazy? What? Do you know how long we've been talking now?
Mm-mm.
Yeah, we've been talking for over 2 hours.
That's a long intro.
Yeah. 2 hours of just these rants. But I don't know. What do you think? Do you think we summed it up in a roundabout way?
Yeah, I mean, and your outline's really good. It's perfect.
Yeah, you gotta stop saying your.
Well,
it's ours.
It's. I kind of feel like I'm like half-assed part of this though, because you totally created like the website and like wrote it all down, and I'm like, yep, I approve. Yep. I mean, I don't know what else to do because I don't know how to do that.
That's a different thing because we're talking about right now. We're exchanging frequencies,
mm-hmm.
right? I tell you, I'm getting weird. I get weird.
Sex of the mind is happening.
Totally, right? You know, but the frequencies and the vibrations that, you know, like you could be emitting to me.
Mm-hmm.
That's why I sent that YouTube link about, I forgot her name.
Was it the Olivia Munn and the...
Yes.
Yeah,
I watched
that just today. I was like, what?
Yes, and then just watching how they were just like going at it. And then
they're just two people
having fucking fun.
Bouncing off
right?
back and forth, yeah.
And then they're both singing.
Yeah.
Yeah, but then it just reminded me, like, we're fucking driving down the highway watching porn. Do you remember that?
Yes, yeah. We were talking. Well, I wasn't watching it. You were looking it up. I was driving.
You were watching
you were
it
because
like,
I. You showed me, and I. What was the one thing? Oh, baby penis.
Baby,
that was. I'm like,
yes.
That's a thing. We were looking up like small penis porn.
Yes,
that's what it was. Yeah.
Yes, and then
baby.
And then you totally. And then it's not like you, but we were both in there. Right, and I'm listening to our recording from when we're on there, and then all of a sudden we're talking about it, and then there's silence.
We're just watching
it. And we talk about it, and then
were my eyes not on the road?
No, they weren't. Your eyes are like this. Right? You know, so they were bouncing back and forth.
Oh,
and then you said something like, yeah, I don't think I've ever done anything like this right here, and then I was agreeing. I was like, yeah, I don't think I've ever done it either, right? But then
like driving and watching porn,
driving and watching smut after we just finished leaving
a squatter settlement
exactly
at, like, the Salton
right
Sea.
I mean, what, that's a fucking beautiful story.
That's
right?
Amazing.
Yeah. This is a beautiful story. You know, we drove out into this abandoned town, right, even though there's people out there. But more or less, they just essentially abandoned it because they fucked it off.
Mm-hmm.
We met up with the squatters, right? At Slab City. Yeah, at Slab City.
I never
City.
Got a picture of East Jesus, or the, not East Jesus, Salvation Mountain.
Yeah, we'll be
back. I can't
back
wait
there.
To go back.
Yeah, but then we go from there, and then they show us around, right? And then they openly embrace us, right? After you said, yeah, let's pick up, you know.
I got so much shit for that, too, for picking up those hitchhikers. Everyone that I told, they were like, are you fucking crazy? Why would you do that? I'm like, okay, well, first of all, Alec was with me. I probably wouldn't have done it had I been by myself.
Yeah.
But I was with another person, and they were like, young kids. It was 110 degrees. I'm like, I felt more than comfortable picking up these people.
Did you tell them I had a machete?
I think I did. I was like, Alec was prepared. He had a giant penis with him. It was in a vagina.
Yes, okay, translation. Penis is Latin for sword, and vagina is Latin for sheath. So,
yeah, so that was
saying
the whole
I had
joke
a sword
that day.
And sheath. Ha, ha, ha.
So funny.
Yeah.
But, yeah, and so many people were like, oh, my God, that's crazy. You should never do that. And I'm like, well, it was kind of like a new experience. Like, I never have done it. Because normally I'm driving by myself, and
right.
I have no reason to do it.
Yeah.
But I've never seen that happen, and it was just totally almost like something out of a book. You know, these guys are standing there, like,
just
hitchhiking. When, I mean, I was like, fuck it. Let's just do it. Let's just pick them up. It's so hot outside.
Yeah.
I mean, I don't regret anything about it. It was so awesome.
No.
It was such a fun experience.
Yeah, it was. The more that I even thought about that, too, you know.
And I kind of almost had like a newfound respect for those type of people, because as I was telling people about it, like what it is that they do, how they live and stuff, and I was saying how like these people like scavenge for food, and like, but they kind of know like when places, like they said the whatever convenience store or whatever was like going to throw away their food and all of that, and like they would.
I prefer the term gather.
Gather.
Yeah.
Gather. And they gathered some yucky food, and I was like, honestly, I don't even know if I could see myself doing that. Like it sounds crazy to me.
Yeah, it would be
and
difficult.
I think it's awesome that they do that though, because we waste a ton of food here.
Oh yeah.
I mean, like so much food.
A shitload of food.
And for people like that, that like know when they're going to get rid of it. Where they're going to get rid of it, and they're just readily like, okay, we need to be here at this time, we're going to get this food and we're going to take it back to our our little habitation.
We have food, we can eat.
That's crazy. It's awesome.
It is. It was
and so
beautiful.
I kind of have like a whole new appreciation for that too.
Yeah, that was to me it was an epic experience too, just
yes,
because of,
absolutely
of,
and I can't wait
that.
To go back
to the gathering.
Squat the world? Is
squat
it?
The planet.
Squat the planet.
Yeah, squat
Why
the
can't
planet.
I remember it?
I don't know. World, planet, same shit.
Yeah.
Right? But, yeah, just to see what's going to happen and what's going to evolve. That's one of the things, too, is that, and I got this concept from another digital mentor where they were talking about that's something that's starting to come about now, is that we're starting to have more and more festivals. Right, so these festivals are taking the place of some form of ritual,
mm-hmm.
right? A ritual that we no longer used to have, right? And then if you look at them, because they happen to be a lot of musical festivals or festivals that are meaningful, like, oh, shit, you know, here's the Symbiosis Festival,
mm-hmm.
right? Which is like they call it the little brother or the little sister to Burning Man. But these are people in California who are saying, how are we going to make our planet better because we're fucking it up? Right, but they're still out there. They're out there with ideas, and they're out there with music,
mm-hmm.
right? And then they're out there coming together like a community. But then you have all these festivals that are just like popping up over and over. And then this is why I have hope. I have
people love that stuff.
Yeah,
and it like brings people together.
Yeah, yeah.
Where they normally wouldn't be.
Yeah, like Salt and Sea,
mm-hmm.
right? Like those people, like going out there, my brain was just like, it was just ramped. I was just going on overdrive looking at like, oh shit, you can do this, you can do that, you can fix this, you can create this out there. You know, there was all sorts of things that I was just thinking. And then, of course, you know, Bitcoin. Right?
Bitcoin.
But thinking about just creating your own economy out there,
mm-hmm.
to where everybody can just function autonomously. I was like,
yeah.
That would be a perfect experiment to run out there.
But that's work. Nobody wants to
yeah,
do that.
Yeah, well,
and they've been living such a lifestyle for who knows how long,
mm-hmm.
you know?
Mm-hmm.
But
yeah.
The idea is there, I mean.
Oh, it totally is, yeah. It totally is, because they already have all the components.
Yeah.
Right? They have their food, water, shelter. Now they can just figure out different ways of creating steady sources of the food, water, shelter.
Mm-hmm.
Right? They have electricity. They have communication. We don't really need that much.
Yeah, it's all overkill.
Yeah.
But we're so used to it. We feel like we need it.
That's the crazy part. Like, you think about some of the things that you actually need. That's all you really need. Food, water, shelter, companionship.
That's the thing. It's like almost everything that we do and that we get and we think. I mean, we don't need 99% of what we have.
And a bitch ain't one.
And a bitch
ain't That was
oh my God.
That was old school Jay-Z.
Old school
yeah.
Jay-Z.
I got 99
Let's give a shout
problems.
Out. And the bitch ain't one.
Yeah. So yeah, go for
oh
it.
Oh my God, that's so funny. I love it. No, just, I mean, literally, like you said, water, food, shelter. Companionship is, I'm on the fence with that. You don't need it. It's desirable. You don't need it, though.
No, I say companionship in order for, tribe. You have to have a tribe. Meaning
yeah.
you this is
so for in order for like a little community or something
yes,
to flourish,
yes,
yeah,
yes,
you do.
Yes,
yeah.
In order for us to succeed properly. Because we're not independent individuals. Even
mm-hmm.
though
even if we were, we would be getting water from somewhere else. It's
yeah.
not like we
mm-hmm.
we found this water.
No,
yeah.
yeah. But it's one of the things that actually made us it allows us to create all this stuff is we understand what the division I burped again. What division of labor does. But it allows
yeah.
us to work in I burped again, a much more efficient way. Meaning that I'll go get this, you go get that, we'll
yeah.
meet up in the middle.
Yeah, and
right?
that's something
Yeah.
That's pretty cool, actually.
Yeah.
And I think that's how they live, like, when I picture them to live at Slab City.
Slab City.
Like, they just all kind of do their own little part, and they kind of combine, pull everything together. All
right.
You know?
We should go camping out there for the weekend.
I'm on call this weekend.
No.
Like,
when
a weekend?
It, yeah, when it cools down.
I want to camp out there when they have their thing. Their
the squat the planet?
Yeah,
let's totally
sure.
plan that.
Definitely.
Yeah, because I would go out there, and it, I haven't been camping in since I was a pup. Yeah.
Okay,
I,
we're doing this.
Yeah.
Totally
so,
doing this.
So, yeah, I was, because I don't mind sleeping out under the stars. Well, I take that back. When I was in the military, that doesn't count, because you're out in the field. So it's not the same as camping.
Okay.
Yeah, but, you know, like being out in the field, because you have to, and you have to build little hospitals and
mm-hmm.
shit like that, versus going out and, yeah, I'm going to pitch a tent.
Yeah.
And then just, like, hang out, like, a yurt. I wish.
A yurt.
Fucking yurt. Like, I've been really thinking about buying a yurt.
I would love to do that. You can rent them. And if you go, I mean, I know, like, in Big Sur, you can rent them
uh-huh.
and stuff.
Uh-huh.
I've always wanted to do that. But.
Oh, I was on. Did you send me this link? I don't know. But it was, maybe. It was, I think it was an image website. But it was about all the different ways that they're actually building different homes for people, especially homeless people, right? And there was one of them. It was like $5. It was like this inflatable home for $5.
Oh my God.
And I was looking at it, and I was like, what? I was like, I need to find it, because I think that could be...
Inflatable
home? It was like an inflatable tent home. Real small, real tiny. Had like a little chimney and all that stuff.
Oh my God.
But it would be totally...
it's like enough to protect you from the elements.
Exactly,
like,
right? Exactly.
That's all you need.
You know, but $5, I'm like, dude, you know, we're up here bugging out and trying to build things. I was like, that would totally be awesome for urban campers.
That's so cool.
Right? You know, the urban campers, and they don't have access because you see some of their stuff. $5, you spend that on Starbucks, right?
Can you get something less than $5 at Starbucks? I don't think so.
Yeah. You know, so a cup of coffee.
That is crazy.
Yeah, you can have a large latte, grande, whatever the fuck they call it, right, at Starbucks, you know, extra whipped cream, blah, 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 $6.50, right? You can say, all right, you know what, I'm going to donate, or I'm going to invest into my community, into my area. Here's a $5 fund so we can go and we can buy some homes for the urban campers, because you know what? The winter is going to be kind of harsh this year, or the summer is going to be kind of harsh.
El Nino's coming.
Yeah, let's protect. You just made noise with that.
I did.
That
might, am I itching? It's because I'm scratching my.
No, brain. It's on the base
this?
With the XLR connection. I heard it.
Oh shit.
Yeah. Ah, it's when you're doing that. Interesting.
Holding it like this?
No, I hear the. Yeah, right there.
Really?
It's scratching. What's up with the connection? Whatever. But yeah, $5 for a little. Yeah, right. For a little. A little home. And then there's another one, and this one's called the eco hut. It's like $3,500.
Okay.
I'm gonna find this one for you.
Okay.
I'm probably gonna buy one.
That's so cool. And it's the same thing though, like inflatable or what?
No, this one is pretty fucking rad.
I'm all about the tiny homes right now.
Yeah.
Have you seen those?
Yeah. This goes along the same line. As the tiny homes. Man, I have so many tabs just on my fucking, on my phone. It's not really a phone. Look at this shit. There's Audacity again. I got Audacity everywhere.
What's that?
It's the software that I use.
Oh.
Yeah. Remember the open source?
Mm-hmm.
You're like, what's that? Alright, I gotta find this. So you're into the tiny homes movement,
mm-hmm.
right? That's what my studio. That's why I came here. It's because I want to do the tiny homes.
That
thing.
Would be so amazing.
Mm-hmm.
There, when I was living in Ramona, they had a company. There's a company out there that's building them,
mm-hmm.
and they had them for sale, like on the side of the road. And every day, I would just slow down and be like, "Oh my God, look how cool!" Like, I emailed them to see, like, you know, what they would cost and whatever. Like,
yeah, how much?
I don't have the. I don't. I'm not ready for that lifestyle yet, but I totally would do that.
Yes, you are.
I have 5 cats.
Oh yeah. Okay. I'm sorry. This is called the Eco Capsule.
Eco Capsule.
Yeah, Eco Capsule. Here, I'll show you some images of it. It's check it out. It's fucking brilliant.
It's like a giant egg.
Yeah.
But oh, and it's got like a little wind turbine solar, or whatever.
It has solar, wind. It's totally self-sufficient.
That's crazy.
Right? I think it's like $3,500. I think it could fit two adults in there. Maybe two small adults.
I want to see pictures of the inside.
Here, let me find it for you. I'll go to the inside.
That's really cool.
Yeah. Okay, these were all the outside, right? But look at that. These little pods.
Yeah.
Right? You get four of them.
Is it like a trailer? Do you drag it somewhere?
No, yeah. Well, yeah. No, it sits on top. Here's inside.
Oh,
it sits
God.
On top, right? So you can just go out there and then you just plop it down. Oh yeah. Do you see the potential in that?
That's crazy.
Right?
Cool.
Now that amount of money, you can create a whole homeless, air quotes here, a city could create a whole homeless shelter, right? And they can buy these. And then they can populate a lot of these little areas.
Look at the storage, too. Like, they're so efficient that, like...
Yeah.
I mean, even... Some of them have, you know, like those... What's it called? Like a Murphy bed, almost. Like, they have fold-in beds that, like, go into the mm-hmm. into the wall.
That's
and,
what
like,
I wanted to do with that, but I'm still debating. Just...
Yeah. Those things are so efficient. I mean, such a good idea.
Yeah, but this eco capsule.
It's crazy.
But this is the potential.
I like that they do... I've seen them built out of old, like, trailers, boxcars, like, storage units, whatever. And they do so many things with them.
Which goes back to our human ingenuity, right? Whenever
it's amazing.
You prohibit people. That's all from prohibition. Because if you make it too expensive for people to go and purchase a home, right, then we'll find different ways. And then now we've said, fuck you, we'll go tiny home living, right?
Yeah,
because we don't need all of this space.
We don't need it, but we feel like we do. But we want it, we just don't need it.
Yeah.
We're like, oh, I want like the mansion and the pool and the five bedrooms and this
and that. The McMansioning.
Yeah. It sounds great, but at the same time, it's like so over the top.
Sounds stupid to me.
It sounds stupid to me.
It does. It's like... Why do you need all that space?
There's a part of me that could appreciate it, I think, but when it comes down to it, like, that tiny home, that little thing there, that pod, that's where I'd be headed.
Yeah, I think that is our future.
Well, I mean, why? Why anything more than that?
Well,
the whole world is your house if you want it to be.
Exactly. What's your background?
Yeah.
What's your backyard look like? All of this? Right? I walk outside and I have all this to plant.
Did you ever watch the documentary on the tiny homes? There was one on Netflix for a while. I don't know if it's still on there.
I think I might have seen a couple. It was about the guy. And
there was one
that
he built his own, yeah. And
then,
yeah, a couple of people they showed that had them. And like some people will, depending on where they want to live, they'll tap into somebody's plumbing or electric or whatever.
Yeah.
But that's optional.
But it's totally all doable. But that's what's so cool about it. But I know, conspiracy tinfoil hat time. I know that a lot of entities, meaning you can say a government or a city council or organizations, would not like that, because now all of a sudden what you've done is you've just freed up people.
Yeah.
From
so we're not paying for electricity. We're not paying for whatever it is.
Which means that now the animals are running loose. Because you have nothing to control them. You can't say
we're free thinkers at that point.
Yeah, you can't say, fuck you, I got a home.
You don't pay property tax over the tiny home, because you take it wherever the fuck you want.
Yeah.
So,
Yeah. Then
that's
they
a
might,
big deal for
they
them,
might
too.
Say, well, you can't live in the city environment. All right, cool. I'll drive out and drive back in.
Yeah,
right?
Exactly. Problem solved.
Yeah. Okay, cool. Oh, you can't control... Oh, I can't work here anymore? Okay, cool. Fuck you. I'll take my home.
Mm-hmm.
And I'll go someplace else. But yeah, that amount of, that's actual proper freedom of movement. And that's one thing that we don't have here in this country. Is because, you know, once you purchase a home, then you are bound to that specific home, that domain.
Right.
Which means that if you start to see the economy go into a different way or next way,
mm-hmm.
then you have something that is anchoring you down. Which means that you're not really that free.
Yeah, so that's what I was just going to say. Like, you own this home, so to speak. You're free, whatever. But you're bound to this.
Yeah.
And if you can't afford it, they'll take it away.
Yeah. Yeah. So do you own it?
You don't own it.
No. You're just paying an extended rent.
Yeah.
Yeah, an extended rent, also called a mortgage.
So unless you can pay it off pretty quickly, you don't own it.
Uh-uh. No. And this is where the illusion of home ownership kicks in. Right? Because then they'll start saying, well, you get all these tax breaks and this and that. And you, oh, well, whatever. Right? It's yours. It's going to be yours one day.
It's going to be yours.
Yeah.
I might not live for the mm-hmm. after like 5 or 10 years. Yeah. Who knows? Like,
yeah.
That's a big commitment. And not to say that I don't ever want that, because I've thought about it, but it's like, I think a lot of people do it, especially now where like we don't really have the means to.
Mm.
We live beyond our means.
Mm.
And that's why we pay mortgages, because we can't afford to just buy a house outright.
Mm.
It's really beyond our means to do that. But then it's like, we feel like we need to do that with everything. We
yeah.
need so much stuff. We feel like we, you know, in order to be happy or to belong or whatever, we need all this stuff.
No, we want it. We don't need
it. We want it.
Yeah, yeah,
yeah.
We don't need. We talked about what we need, right? We need
water, food, shelter,
companionship. Water, food, shelter. Yeah, my mic. Yeah, I just got close to the mic and I heard it. Yeah, but that's all we really
yeah.
need. Everything else is just all, this is what you would call luxury.
Yeah.
Luxury is waste. Anything that's luxurious is waste.
Mm-hmm.
You don't fucking need it. So then you're just wasting your energy, you're wasting your time, even though you say, it makes me feel... Can you do your voice with that?
Oh.
About something makes you feel so good.
It makes me feel so good to have access. It's luxury. It's just...
Yeah.
It makes me feel so good.
Yeah, yeah.
It makes you feel taken care of. Like, you have more than you need, so you don't need to worry about anything.
Yeah.
But it's wasteful.
It is. It's very wasteful.
And then, after you've enjoyed it, it's like, okay.
Yeah, and how long does it take
you to
put it
last. Something? It's not, yeah, it's not indefinite.
This felt so good for 2 minutes.
That's what she said.
Yeah, oh God, I'm over it. I'm over it.
Oh,
yeah, I'm moving on to the next. Ah. Shit.
That was
all right.
Awesome.
Yeah. Sorry. So then this was basically our intro.
Yeah, this was
yeah.
our intro.
This is the first one. So we're going to dedicate this one as Mind Slut 1.
Mind Slut 1.
Yeah, I don't know how we're going to label it, but this will be our very very first proper podcast. Even though we've spoken and we've had fun and we've been doing
all sorts
of...
We were working out the bugs before,
yeah,
though.
Yeah. Fucking mic checks up the ass. Right? And then this one still might sound shitty, but right now, we don't care because we're just putting it out there. MVP, minimal viable product, because now we're just going to fucking grow. Yeah, we will just grow. So, so you have the what, why, how, and the rules of conduct that we are going to be conducting with ourselves on world famous Mind Slut.